From high atop Memorial Stadium here in Berkeley, you can barely see the skyline of San Francisco with all the clouds and conditions expected to worsen throughout the afternoon. Oregon set to take on the Cal Bears, and Todd Harris down on the field. Bit of trading places situation with the quarterbacks today, Todd.
Well, Terry, David, you remember that great movie back in the 80s with Eddie Murphy and Dan Aykroyd trading places? Well, we've got college football's version of the exact same thing. Jeremiah Masoli from San Francisco, he made the trek north to play for the Oregon Ducks, and Kevin Riley, who was from the Beaverton area of Portland, Oregon, he decided to bring his act down south to Cal. Now, both quarterbacks really run their offense. The teams depend on them to perform. I talked with both coaches, and both of them said, you know, we looked at them. They just weren't right for our system, but they have found homes at their respective school. And who says you can't go home again? Over my right shoulder, that's 168 members of Jeremiah Masoli's friends and family. We'll hear from them later in the game. Terry?
Hey, Todd, it's growing because he told us it's going to be about 150 the other day. So now you've got 168 here.
He had to come up with another 18.
Yeah, exactly. And a lot of Ducks fans here in Berkeley today to watch this critical matchup. 64 degrees, that's deceiving. It is dropping. They're expecting it to get much cooler throughout the afternoon. Some heavy driving rain at times and wind gusts up to 25 miles an hour. So Mike Bellotti in his 14th year as the head coach of the Ducks. 6-2 overall, 4-1 in the Pac-10, and Cal coming in 5-2 and 3-1 in Pac-10 play. So you've got those four teams with one loss in Pac-10 play. And, of course, Cal really just getting into the heart of their schedule right now. Oregon won the toss. They defer to the second half. Jeremy Ross back deep. Matt Evenson gets us underway here in Berkeley. Ross from his own goal line, bringing it back this way. Got a seam outside. Finally tripped up at the 36. So a good return for Ross and good start for the Cal offense, led by Kevin Riley, the sophomore, as Todd said, from Beaverton, Oregon, and down here in the Bay Area now 4-1 as a starter this season, David.
Yeah, Kevin Riley last week, he was a slow starter at the quarterback position, getting the start after Nate Longshore had started a couple games for the Bears. But Riley really found his feet late in the third quarter, made some nice plays in the fourth quarter, and Jeff Tedford said what he did best in the game against UCLA is he took care of the football.
Will Taufo'o, the fullback, ahead of this man right here, Javid Best, one of the best tailbacks in the Pac-10, ahead for a gain of about 3 on first down. Our impact players brought to you by Best Buy, Best averaging 107 yards per game, second best in the Pac-10. But here's the guy that's really emerged, Verann Tucker.
Yeah, Verann Tucker is a big play guy down the field. He's a solid threat over the top. Big size, nice speed. And then Mike Muhammad last week, a couple of interceptions, including one returned for a touchdown. Muhammad was all over the field as a non-starter at linebacker.
Direct snap to Javid Best this time as they spread Kevin Riley out wide, and he gets ahead for a couple. So a little different look from Jeff Tedford. And you would expect that as you look at the starting lineups up on the top of your screen. We talked to the coaches for Cal this week, and they say, you know what, we know Jeff's going to have something up his sleeve. We saw the flea flicker last week against UCLA.
That's right. Nick Aliotti, the defensive coordinator for Oregon, said he's got enough talent, Jeff Tedford does, that he doesn't need the gadget plays, but he still runs them.
So it's 3rd and 4. Sean Young in motion to the far side. Riley out of the shotgun. Look this side quickly. This one's tipped up, and it might have been picked off. Intercepted. Spencer Paysinger comes up with the tip football. Paysinger, the sophomore from L.A.
Now, we talked about Jeff Tedford and Kevin Riley a week ago making good decisions, took care of the football. Tedford's defense came up with 4 interceptions, but this week early, Kevin Riley with a bad decision to let that football go.
Yeah, and he was hit as he started to throw, and it looked like it may have slipped out of his hands. And they will take a look at it. They take a look at everything, but they'll take a closer look at this one. So a big play. We'll see if it stands. Looked like it should, as Oregon would have the football when we come back. The play stands as it was called on the field. So Spencer Paysinger, the sophomore from Beverly Hills High School, comes up with his first interception this year and a big one to stop this opening drive and turn it over, give it back to Oregon. So it's Jeremiah Masoli who's from the Bay Area, the Pac-10 Offensive Player of the Week, coming off that performance against Arizona State last week. Quick throw out wide. Got his man, Jason Williams, to the 40-yard line just outside of that. Take you back to that last play, the turnover, and it was really the pressure from the outside, David.
It was. Nick Reed, number 49, applies the pressure. Just an uncanny ability, number 49, to get to the passer. Leads the Pac-10 conference in sacks. One of the sack leaders across the country.
Jeremiah Johnson, the carry on second down. He's got a first. They'll move the chains. They haven't run him down yet. You've got Johnson, who goes 5'10", 200 pounds. Their second leading rusher. And then you can bring in LeGarrette Blount, who's 6'2", 240 yards and leads them. That's a gain of 13. So that's a great choice that you have with your running backs. And Andre Crenshaw, another one who they'll use a lot of. They'll place it down at the 27. Masoli with time throws over the middle, wide open. Jason Williams, another catch, trying to fight his way close to a first down. And this offense giving you a lot to look at, going right through Cal's defense at the moment, at least. Take a look at our Best Buy impact players. Masoli, certainly one of them, not only throwing but also running. But his favorite target today so far, Williams.
Yeah, Jason Williams. They need to get the ball to him more often to exploit his size advantage over defensive backs. He's had some drop problems catching the football. And then Nick Reed has already made an imprint on this game early.
Yeah, Williams gets a lot of attention by the defenses. Here comes Masoli looking to run. Gets a block from Williams. Gets outside. Gets to the end zone. Touchdown, Oregon. And, man, did they make it look easy. ...17 yards to the end zone and six on the board. Just like that. Couple of blocks from his wideouts and an easy run for six. Matt Evenson on for the extra point. And it's dropped. They'll have to try to run it or throw it in. Nope, not going to get there. Back here in Berkeley, remember they're getting new facilities too. The new Student Athlete Center just outside of Memorial Stadium. And we'll see that construction underway there. And they're going to redo the stadium itself. Going to redo the defense right now. Oregon went right through them. Didn't we just do this? Evenson to kick off. Ross back deep. Jeremy coming up to the nine. Across the 25, he'll be stopped at the 29. Let's check in for the first time today back in Manhattan, our Times Square studio. Matt Weiner, what's going on?
Brought down by number 32, Jairus Byrd of the Ducks. A 20-yard return to the 29. First down, Bears.
Crazy ACC race this year and Pac-10 race now here in the West. They're going to whistle this one dead before it gets underway.
Dead ball, illegal snap on the offense, 5-1. 5-yard penalty, still first down.
And an offensive line for Cal that's banged up and some substitutes starting today. Justin Cheadle getting a start at right guard. Donovan Edwards moves over to right tackle. You've got both of the right tackles, the starter and the second stringer, out today.
Yeah, Chet Teofilo and Matt Laird both went down last week against UCLA, and against the pass rush of the Oregon Ducks, especially these defensive ends, going to be an interesting matchup to watch.
Wiley with time throws it away. No chance for that one. So an inauspicious start for Kevin Riley, the sophomore.
And you have defensive ends like Will Tukuafu and Nick Reed, number one and number two in the Pac-10 in sacks as well as tackles for losses. The defensive end that finds that right side of the Cal Bears line figures to test Mr. Edwards throughout this afternoon.
Yeah, this is not an easy Oregon Duck defense to go against, especially if you get down early and you're trying to come back and you have to throw the football. Second and 15, low snap. Dangerous pass again high. Varan Tucker, the intended receiver. It's a matchup last last year. Remember how big this game was up in Eugene. Both teams ranked at that point. Cal really on the move. Number 6 against number 11. And it was a great one, too.
It really was. And, you know, this game did not only figure into the Pac-10 race at the time, it had major BCS implications. DeSean Jackson had a nice game for Cal. And then, of course, Cameron Colvin trying to stretch the ball to tie the game at 31 across the goal line. The hit by Marcus Ezef. Touchback.
To save the game. Riley throws on the run, got his man, and that's a first down. Varan Tucker juggled it and then able to hold on. They'll move the chains. Right in front of TJ Ward.
It is going to be a challenge for both of these offenses to handle the football. The rain, as you said, Terry, driving at times. Tucker looked like he had a problem securing the football. It looks like he did control it before he went out of bounds.
DJ Ward, the man from DSL High School, the Bay Area, guy who's gone through 3 knee surgeries, former walk-on, wasn't really recruited, had a tough senior year because of injuries in high school, and here he is starting. He's had a great career. Shane Vereen in for Javid Best, and we'll see a lot of him, their second leading rusher with about 500 yards on the year now.
And not much of a drop-off with Vereen when he comes in the lineup. An electric talent at tailback when you have a job at best in the game. But Vereen has shown that he can crack off the long run. Had an 81-yarder in the opener against Michigan State to put that game away.
Had 99 yards last week against UCLA, and Best went over 100 yards again. He had 115 yards and a touchdown, and Javid back in now. Going to swing it out to him. Trying to get outside. He does initially and then hauled in. Good tackle out at the 47. That was Jerome Bird. Looked like he got by him and just reached out and pulled him back.
Yeah, that's a solid play by Bird. Not many outside linebackers in the conference match up well with Javid Best in the open field. And the tackling, especially in space, Terry, is going to be a big part of this game, especially for Cal's defense when they're operating against the Oregon spread. That might have been a face mask.
Had him high. I'm not sure he got him up with the face mask, but it was close. Best with the rest on this play. Had a foot injury, bit of an ankle injury in the last week or so. Pass is complete to the 30 of Oregon. And it's Tucker high in the air with a catch. And a gain of 23.
We talked about the emergence of Tucker, a guy who's just feeling his way into football at the college level. Great size and the ability to go up and get the football. Very strong with his hands. And a guy who gives Kevin Riley big play options on the perimeter.
Now from El Camino Community College, so he's a JUCO transfer, came in, took him a while to get adjusted, and he's gotten better each week. First and 10, Ross in motion back this way. Vereen, the carry. To the 25. Close to it. Vereen, the freshman from Valencia. And a tackle by TJ Ward.
The rain has let up a bit. And I think this is good for California. You know, Oregon is a running offense, basically. But the wet doesn't necessarily help the Ducks that much, even though they have a running offense, because of the pitches, the decision making, the short throws. Both quarterbacks, I think, in this game want to see the dry weather.
Riley under center on 2nd and 6. Quick throw to the fullback, Cafone, who's just pounded as soon as he catches it. TJ Ward quickly with the hit. Now you look at a guy who has just not only paid his dues, but had, he's gone through a little bit of everything and just never given up throughout his career.
That was a big hit applied by Ward. And the Ducks have made a bit of a transition at their safety positions. Ward, who is listed as a free safety, is playing more as a strong safety. And Patrick Chung, the All-American candidate, has been the guy that's played more of the free safety type over the top.
Ninth play of the drive for Cal. Ross to the end zone, touchdown. Jeremy Ross with the catch and a perfect strike from Kevin Riley. 22 yards.
A
Well, a week ago against UCLA, Jeff Tedford wasn't thrilled with the performance of his quarterback, but he went back, watched the tape, and afterwards said it was better than he first thought. He made a number of nice throws in the game. Giorgio Tavecchio from Italy on for the extra point. Great drive for Cal and Kevin Riley, 5 for 5, 72 yards on that drive, and they were 3 for 3, David, on third down.
Kevin Riley was impressive. Had a slow start. As we mentioned last week, not much production from this pass game of the Cal Bears through three quarters a week ago. But in the rain this afternoon, Riley appeared to get comfortable as that drive wound to its close.
Tavecchio puts it in the air. Chung and Crenshaw back deep. Chung brings it back across the 25 and then swung back. Just hit a wall.
The releases are important as we look at our Best Buy playbook. This is Ross at the bottom. Press coverage and watch him shake and get upfield, and then Chung's going to be late getting over the top. Nice ball from Riley as he puts it on Ross's numbers. That's great execution. That right foot loaded. That's putting the ball on a spot.
First and 10 from the 27. Now, the last time Oregon had the ball, remember how easy it looked marching down the field and picking up 6. They'll go straight ahead this time. Jeremiah Johnson with the carry. And you would expect them to try to run north-south against this 3-4 defense. First time all year they've faced that type of defense.
Yeah, three defensive linemen, 4 linebackers. Unusual front. Mike Bellotti doesn't see that week in and week out, but as a defense, you've got to defense the dive, the keep, and the pitch.
Here comes Johnson reversing field, coming back this way. Looking for a seam. Gets more than he perhaps should have, and should have a first down, and a late flag comes in. Marcus Ezev on the hit after the gain of 7.
Ezev, the defender, penalty 5 on the play.
Personal foul, face mask on the defense, number 26. 15-yard penalty, automatic first down.
Yeah, so that's costly.
Darian Hagan, the cornerback. No more 5-yarders on face masks.
Bob Gregory in his 7th year, defensive coordinator for Cal, trying to figure out how to stop this offense. Based on what you've seen so far, they haven't been able to do it, right? And they're trying to figure it out.
Well, the best way to stop this offense, and it's easier said than done, is to beat this offensive line at the line of scrimmage and get penetration.
Masoli's going to keep it this time, use his speed. We'll look at what he can give you other than throwing the football. To the far sideline, knocked out. Not a bad game, though. Darian Hagan, the man who ran him out. 279 yards rushing per game, most in the Pac-10.
Well, the reason why they're so tough to stop is that they can make you wrong on almost every play. I mean, Masoli's capable of giving the ball on the dive. He can keep the ball outside, and then he's got the option to pitch.
He's going to throw this one, or looking to throw at least. He can run it now. Knocked out a little bit late at the 40. Zach Follett chased him down, and he'll play a large role today, that outside linebacker spot, right, trying to read who's going to keep the football and whether or not it's going to be Masoli, Johnson, whether it's Blunt.
Follett's really the heartbeat of the pass rush at times. He's capable of playing up on the line of scrimmage. He can lock up on the tight end, and he's also pretty darn good out in space against the pass.
Cal was great on third down on their drive, and this is 3rd and 5 for the Ducks. Under pressure, Masoli, who I don't think you ever saw Zach Follett till it was too late.
Well, ask and you shall receive, Terry Gannon. Zach Follett up on the line of scrimmage as a linebacker, and he's never going to quit on this play. He keeps coming. He beats Tupou outside, and that's not an easy task, tracking down Masoli from behind.
Man has a sense of television. You mentioned his name, he makes the hit. Josh Cyrie's punt. They scramble towards the goal line. They're going to knock this one back. And it'll be a touchback. They always wait on that signal until the ball's actually dead. In the crowd, you always get a reaction from the crowd.
Well, the ball clearly broke the plane, and that's the rule in the college ranks. In the NFL, it's really all about where the player is, whether the player's stepping in the end zone. But the ball breaks a plane in college, and it's a touchback. Taking one more look. Back judge. Right on top of the call, and it's a good one.
Yeah, he throws the beanbag down in the end zone. So they'll bring it out to the 20 for Cal.
The key is that the play doesn't end at that point. Once the ball is touched, you know, Cal Bears can pick up the ball and return it. So Oregon, even though they make contact with the football, Oregon has to make sure that a Bear doesn't pick it up and try to return it.
While they wait, yep. First and 10 from the 20. Gonna hand it off. Here comes Best. Javid breaks free. Still up. With the hesitation, he lost the football at the end. The scramble, T.J. Ward was there, and it's Oregon football after a great run by Best. He lost it. And they've already given the signal. The Ducks have it. Rashawn Harris, the man at the end of that scramble who came up with it. And now the committee meets.
Job at Best, getting some great blocking up front, and that ball is out early.
Well, what a great hesitation move on the sideline, though, just to stop cold, and then he's hit. It was T.J. Ward knocked it free.
And a great play by Ward to make the strip, and then how about the defensive tackle, Rashawn Harris, trailing the play all the way down the field.
50 yards on that, but they turn it over, and now two turnovers by the Bears. So they'll place it at the 30, and Masoli takes over again. Johnson in the backfield is going to get the call this time. Looking for a block, nowhere to go. Runs into those gold jerseys. First time they've ever worn the gold jerseys and pants, by the way. And you know all about Oregon and their what they do with their uniforms. But Cal pulling a little bit of uniform trickery out today.
Yeah, the Bears look sharp. And, of course, Oregon, I think they figured out Oregon can go with over 600. Pants and jersey combinations. It's true.
I know it is. It's just ridiculous. Second and 12. Masoli throws on the run. Got a man and a flag. Goes down right there. Jeff Mayo on the catch. Scrambles without the helmet.
You look at the Ducks uniforms. More costume changes than a Madonna show.
I thought you were going Cher for a minute. I guess I'm a little dated on that. Madonna. Okay.
Could he use Liberace?
Goes against Oregon, and the Oregon offensive players were over there trying to figure out what exactly they did. They got Dixon, the tight end. And Tedford, they'll explain it to him, see if he wants to take it.
Illegal touching on the offense, number 23. Went out of bounds, returned inbounds, and caught the pass. Penalties declined because you did not gain to the line of scrimmage. Down will be two.
Okay.
As a receiver, you can't leave the field of play and come back in and be the first player to touch the football unless, of course, you're forced out by a defender.
Well, we got a little explanation, too. Didn't reach the line of scrimmage, and that's why they declined. You don't really forget that, David. Third and 12. Masoli throws dangerous. Knocked down. Darian Hagan at the last minute. It's a defense that really they get their hands on a lot of passes.
Well, they do, and they're playing a lot more zone than they have in games past and years past. And they have done a great job. You just go back to last week, the way underneath defenders were getting out, getting their hands on footballs. And it has translated to big plays and interceptions for the Bears.
Over the head of Cyree out of the back of the end zone. Touchback. All right, so we've seen the fumble, the interception. Now this one through the back of the end zone. And even though and the rain is falling right now, it's not all that hard. Conditions playing a role.
But the rain is coming to hard down hard enough to create all sorts of problems in the ball handling department. That looked like Zach Taylor, the long snapper.
So you get the safety and 2 points. That wasn't even close.
Luckily for Oregon, that ball had enough mustard on it to get through the end zone and out of the back of the end zone. You don't want to see one of those recovered for six.
So two more on the board with the safety, and it's 9-6. A reminder, he's a boxing coach who saved countless kids from the streets. Now Sugar Ray Leonard, George Foreman, Oscar De La Hoya join the Extreme team to give them one knockout of a makeover. All Street new Extreme Makeover Home Edition tomorrow, 8-7 Central on ABC. A show that's been on for a long time, and my kids love that thing. You know, watch it every Sunday.
I've been waiting forever for those guys to show up and give me a home makeover.
I don't think, how many homes? You got like 7 or 8 homes.
Yeah, but they all
choose from.
But they all need makeovers. That's my point.
That's a problem. It's a bad time to need makeovers on your home too, or plural homes.
So you gotta have six. You gotta have some cash on hand because you're certainly not going to get a loan.
Hey, a little bit of everything. We got the safety, a couple of turnovers. 9-6 your score right now in this one. Is we actually see, is that the sun peeking through a little bit?
Well, I'll tell you what, I'm an old Oregon man myself, grew up in Portland, and I did not enjoy playing in the rain. You're handling the football as a skill athlete, even as a long snapper, it's not a lot of fun.
Saquon Thompson at his own 30. Dances around, brings it back out to the 45. So the Cal offense back to work and trying to hold on to it. They had the one solid drive throughout the year. It has been their running game. Javid Best leading the way, almost, well, he's got over 107 yards on the ground per game. Kevin Riley gaining confidence as a starter, but remember Nate Longshore, if Riley isn't producing, they've got him to go to.
Kevin Riley was named the starter just prior to the opener by Jeff Tedford, and he was unseated as a starter by Nate Longshore 3 games ago. It's the accuracy and slow starts that Tedford pointed out asked Kevin Riley his job for a couple games.
Play action, which has given the Ducks some trouble, but again, Nick Reed all over Kevin Riley as he throws it away. And Best, even though he's not returning because of the injuries, the elbow injury, the foot and the ankle area, still third in all-purpose yards in all of college football. And Cal with 5 wins, trying to become bowl eligible today for the win. Quick throw on the out. Tucker a little bit too high for him. Check out Matt Weiner in the studio right now. Matt, what do you have?
Hi, Terry. I've got our nominee for the AT&T ESPN All-America Player of the Week. Northwestern quarterback Mike Kafka filling in for the injured C.J. Beshay, and his first start of the season was a very good one. 359 total yards and a couple of touchdowns in the Wildcats' dramatic road win against Minnesota. Cast your vote. Text the word vote to 51234 on your AT&T wireless phone.
Back here, wet conditions in Berkeley. 3rd and 10 for the Cal offense. Riley with time, flushed out now, nowhere to go. Finally finds Tucker, tipped up, almost picked off. Flags come in. Walter Thurman, who was beaten by Jeremy Ross on the last touchdown catch, may have come in early.
The Oregon Ducks have a set of cornerbacks that are as good.
On the defense, number 32. 15-yard penalty, automatic first down.
A couple cornerbacks on this Oregon roster that are as good as you'll find on the West Coast. Jairus Byrd and Walter Thurman the third. And Jairus Byrd's going to get flagged on this play. Riley, a nice job stepping up into the pocket. Boy, it looked like Byrd timed that pretty well. And the flag came in late.
Todd Harris, what do you have?
Well, Terry, I think Jairus Byrd might have taken secondary coach John Neal's advice to heart. Coach Neal told them on the last change of possession, he said, we are not hammering these guys. Let's go out there and start hammering them. Secondary's not getting it done.
Yep, and they've had problem against that the past throughout the year. The coaches will tell you in part because the offense, what they do with the spread, number of plays.
Well, and it's interesting because it was Thurman that played Tucker as the ball arrived. And The officials called the flag on Jarris Bird, number 32. I don't think it was something that happened off the ball there, Terry. The officiating crew might have just called the wrong number.
I agree with you. I think that's it was Thurman on the coverage.
I thought it was a pretty good play by Thurman. Timed it up fairly well.
Brings up second and six, and Riley out of the shotgun now. Inside give, here comes Vest. Hit for a couple, but they'll be shy. So bring up third down. Check out our city X Factor, David.
Well, of course, with Oregon, you got to tackle in space. They're going to find you. They're going to find one-on-one situations with their skill athletes on offense. You've got to have one of your best games tackling. And then for California, you know, no big plays for Best. Actually, that should be for under the Oregon Ducks. But you want to limit Javid Best. He's so capable of springing the long runs.
Remember how good they were on that long drive on third down. Third and four now. Riley under pressure throws out Tucker, but it looks like he's going to be short. Good play by Thurman, the man who was involved. Well, let's see. Let's see what they give him a pretty good spot.
These Duck corners are playing aggressively. They're sitting on routes.
Yeah, you got it, David. Was enough.
Move the chains, and Riley's having to get the ball out quickly. Both Thurman and Bird are dropping back in secondary coverage, and they're planting their feet and they're jumping routes.
Shane Vereen in that tailback. Taufoʻu, the fullback. Here comes your. Now I know Nick is quick, but he's not that quick.
Ball start number five offense.
Drawn off.
Ball start. On the offense, number five. 5-yard penalty, steal first down.
Cameron Mora. The tight end. And their leading receiver. You look at the way this offense has been structured throughout the year. You go to their tight end, and Best is right there, second leading receiver. The two guys they want to get the ball to any way they can.
And Jeff Tedford's offense is always exploit you with the tailback, the tight end, and the fullback in the pass game.
Play action, Riley. Looking to get it this way. He's going to tuck it and run. Hit hard at the 22, and there are late flags back at the 35, so we'll check that out.
I think it's going to be a hold against Cal.
After the gain of 12, and Riley's shaken up.
This might have gone against Alex Mack. Taking a look at Riley and his ability to get upfield and take a lick.
Well, he got hit by both Chung and Ward. So free safety, strong safety, take your pick.
Riley, a little slow getting up. When you're playing at this level, you got to be a little hesitant about lowering the crown of your helmet when you're running the ball at quarterback.
So they work on Riley down on the field, and Longshore is going to put the helmet on and throw a few on the sideline. Yeah, Kevin's. At least he's walking off under his own power right now, but he's a little woozy. Trying to get the crowd up into it, though. Now, you mentioned Alex Mack. You got two of the best centers in college football, certainly the two best in the Pac-10. Mack and Max Unger on the other side today.
A very rare holding call going against Alex Mack. You talk about number 51, great leader on the field for Cal at center. Tremendous in the classroom.
All right, so Nate Longshore comes on, the senior from Canyon Country, who's had a terrific career here at Cal. Had three starts earlier this year, his sixth appearance. Here he is throwing to the near sideline. Didn't get warmed up, and he's trying to throw. They're first and 25 on that one. We get a Sports Center right now update from John Saunders. John?
Rotarian is powered by Vizio. 26 seconds left in the game. Northwestern and Minnesota. Adam Weber back to pass. Brendan Smith steps in front of it, and look at the blocking he has. 48 yards for the game-winning touchdown. We already have three top 25 teams have lost this week, including Minnesota.
It's been a wacky year of college football, though things had settled down the last couple of weeks. Unsure over the middle, and it's Marine out of the backfield. Good run after the catch to get it near the original line of scrimmage. A gain of 11.
So many teams up and down the conference have had problems with injuries at the quarterback position. Jeff Tedford with the rare luxury of having two quarterbacks that are high-level passers. Taking a look at Kevin Riley there on the sidelines. But Nate Longshore has displayed the ability to deliver the ball with accuracy over the last 3 years here at Cal.
Yeah, one of the best back in 06. And the injury last year. And the fans, though, this year have been very vocal in wanting Riley to run the show. Longshore out of the gun, under pressure. He's pounded, and so is the receiver, Tucker, as that ball's delivered. T.J. Ward there. I mean, take your pick. Longshore got hit, and then Tucker got hit.
This has been a physical football game early. Nate Longshore sitting in is going to take a hit on release. Right in the chops. And then watch the...
Oh.
That is a big-time hit by Ward to finish off the pass receiver.
Hey, David, think about the hits just on this drive alone. We saw the Ward Chung hit on Riley and then two on that one.
You have to be careful when you're a quarterback leading your wide receivers into hard spots. And Jeff Tedford, lucky that his team still has the football.
So Cal burns a timeout in this 71st meeting between Oregon and Cal back in 1899, the first meeting. It was a doozy, wasn't it?
Yeah.
Last year, great one in Eugene.
All sorts of offense.
And the last win here for the Ducks in 2001.
It was a great game a year ago. And going into that game, not only Pac-10 implications, but it figured highly into the BCS picture at the time. Autzen Stadium was on fire.
As it often is up there.
You know, it's really interesting. You know, you go back to the 80s, and there was a time where Autzen Stadium was not much of a factor in terms of noise. In fact, it was one of the more quieter venues in the Pac-10. As a starting quarterback, you always hated to go up into Seattle, the Huskies, the way the defense and the crowd would get involved. And then, you know, under the early part of Bilotti's tenure, started ratcheting up the noise. Looks like they're going for it.
Yeah, so they talk it over and they figure with the field position right here, they're going to go for it on fourth and 14. Longshore stepping up, man over the middle, complete, and that's a first down. Jeremy Ross going down low to pick that one off the turf. How about that?
Well, how about the decision by Jeff Tedford? You know, figuring, hey, I might end up punting the ball out of the end zone. I might not pick up great field position. The throw is there, and that is a crisp route by Ross. You know, squaring off the dig route. Ross is really starting to emerge as a wide receiver for Jeff Tedford.
Well, he's the one who had the touchdown catch earlier in the game. His second catch of the day, moving the chains, big pickup. Longshore throwing it away. A little extra after the play was done.
Yeah, you can tell that the quarterbacks are having some problems with the wetness on the football. And, you know, Terry, oftentimes you're not really sure what sort of grip you're going to have on the football until you receive the snap, whether it's under center or whether it's in the shotgun. There are plays where the officials do a better job of wiping off the football. And there's that split second moment where you get the ball in your hands as a quarterback and you say, uh-oh, you know, I'm not going to be able to deliver the football.
In your mind as you're releasing it, are you a little bit tentative too because of that?
Absolutely, absolutely. I think we saw it on the last pass by Longshore.
Second down, Longshore throwing a little bit high, but Vereen high into the air to make the catch down at the 10. And a gain of 8.
That was an impressive ball by Longshore. He had to shade that ball to the inside. And you look at the comparison, Kevin Riley 4-1 as a starter, but I think Nate Longshore has really done well when he has been asked to play at the position. And I felt, you know, he played really well down at Arizona through three quarters before they went back to Kevin Riley as a starter.
Vereen in that tailback now on 3rd and 2. And give it off to Shane, looks for a hole, powers his way, it'll be close.
You hear so much about the Ducks pass rush and the numbers from the defensive ends. Of course, Nick Reed, three returning starters in the secondary, three-year starters in the secondary. This Duck defense has been very good against the run. But they're getting a taste of just how versatile this offense is for California. Two quarterbacks who can throw the ball exceptionally well and a great mix of run and pass.
Frank Cignetti, the offensive coordinator, and Tedford, too, two of the better offensive minds. Boy, look at this. First down. As close as it gets.
Well, of course, Tedford is a product of the Oregon offensive scheme. A lot of great assistance over the years coming out of Eugene as we take a look at the booth.
At the conclusion of today's game, by the way, we'll select a Chevrolet player of the game from each team. Chevrolet making a $1,000 contribution to each university's general scholarship fund. All right, final seconds coming off the clock here in the first, trying to get 7 on the board. Cal with another drive. Straight ahead, not much going on. Green getting the bulk of the work in this series. Best had that long run and then fumbled, 50-yard run and then fumbled, and Vereen now on. And they'll place it at the 5. 2nd and goal coming up. When we come back to Berkeley, changing the quarterbacks, the hit on Riley, the reason, a big-time hit. He goes to the sideline. Nate Longshore picking up a big 4th down as I'm knocking on the door. Back here in Berkeley, Cal up 9-6 over Oregon. Critical matchup in the Pac-10. Both teams with just 1 loss in conference play so far. 2nd and goal from the 5. Longshore in place of Riley, who was knocked out on this drive earlier. Nate, incomplete.
Just so you guys know.
So it brings up 3rd and goal.
Taking the look back one more time on the hit that knocked Riley out of the game, Mr. Bird. And that was pretty close to helmet on helmet. I know you can't always size up where you're going to deliver the blow on defense. That was a nice clean hit, even though there was some helmet to helmet activity.
It was close. 3rd and goal. Vereen in that tailback. Quick drop, throwing it up, fade to Tucker, incomplete, but a flag comes in. Thomas Jackson, the 3rd, the defender.
And Tucker's a tough matchup proposition. And if they're going to drop a flag, that's going to go against Jackson. Got into his jersey a little bit. Tucker, nice job to show the officials that the ball was catchable. Looks like they might.
They might
be looking at Tucker.
Looked like Jackson was celebrating a little bit as the flag came in.
Pass interference on the offense, number 86. Penalties declined, down as 4.
So it brings up 4th down. And based on Jackson's reaction to that, thought it might go against Cal.
Well, let's watch here. Let's watch the hand play. Yeah, maybe there with the left hand. I thought there was some contact from both the receiver and the defensive back. It didn't look like Tucker really extended with that left arm from that angle. It's tough to see the left arm against the chest of Jackson.
So Giorgio Tavecchia from Moraga, California, and originally Milan. There's a bad snap again. Snap was low. The Ducks come up with it. So again, you see a miscue. loom large. Yeah, we come back here in the second quarter. It's second and goal from the five, and they get nothing out of it, David.
Well, the rain continuing to come down. The football is just going to get tougher to handle. Special teams handling the football has been a nightmare.
Another miscue looming large here. 9-6, Cal in the lead, but they were knocking on the door. Should have had at least three, if not seven, on the board.
And the snappers and the holders are having a heck of a time taking care of the football in this pounding rain.
It's not getting any better either. But Garrett Blunt looks for room. He comes on for Jeremiah Johnson's. Actually, their leading rusher falls ahead for a gain of about two. That's it. But this has been the story so far, David.
Well, and you can get a feel as we look at Tightwad Hill. Sparse crowd watching the game for free. Holds have been a problem. The snap over the punter's head.
Now it's
two points.
Snap.
Nate Longshore having trouble handling that football, even though it was a good snap.
The rain even heavier right now. Foley throws over the middle, complete. Drew Davis is the man as he's driven back. We check in once again with Matt Weiner.
All right, Terry, let's get you a Verizon Wireless update on Florida and Georgia and what amounts to a BCS championship eliminator today. This is Percy Harvin accepting the pitch. 10th touchdown on the season to make it 7-0. Florida's driving again. In fact, they're on the Georgia 6. It is 7-3 Gators. Alabama out of conference and on top, 14-0 at the half.
The tide is rolling. Masoli looking to throw, throws it away. Davis was out there. It's getting worse, too, right now. That rain is driving. The wind is picked up. There you see. Tightwad Hill is not the place you want to be today. You might slide right down that hill to the stadium.
Not unless you have a real trusty tarp up there. I don't want to think about pitching a tent.
I mean, it might be free, but I'm not sure I want to go up there today. Dangerous walking up. That brings up fourth down. Josh Cyree going to punt it away to Saquon Thompson. Back at his own 30, and look right up into that ring. That's a good punt, too. Man, all the way back to the 10. Sid back out to the 18. So Cyree with a 59-yard punt. Check out our Pacific Life game summary. The Ducks, Spencer Pasinger with that interception leading to that first drive. Masoli, an easy run to the end zone, but Best with 57 yards, 50 of those on one run, but then he fumbled.
Yeah, and if there's been a key play that you could point to early in this football game, it was the fumble after the long run by Best. And Harris, a terrific job, the defensive tackle for Oregon, getting all the way downfield to cover that fumble.
So Longshore back in to run the show. Javid Best back in at tailback. Nyan Boateng in motion, coming back this way. First down. Best gets the call right into that defensive front, not going anywhere, and that ball's loose. Waiting for a signal, the Ducks have come up with it. Nick Reed, the man who's everywhere.
I think it's safe to say that you can throw a lot of the X's and O's out the rest of the afternoon. The premium on handling the football is what is going to determine this football game. And execution, like snaps, handoffs, just the rudimentary execution items become a huge challenge. Oregon pretty stout at the point of contact.
Second fumble, David, for Javid Best. Didn't look like he ever really had that one. Masoli under pressure. Still up. Gets away. Throws off his back foot. Gets rid of it. Just to get rid of that. What a play. Warrell Williams had him.
That was a terrific play by Masoli, and we saw the same type of play last week down in Tempe. Masoli, I don't know how he escaped Williams. Williams is one of the better blitzing linebackers.
You know how strong he's got to be as a quarterback to get away?
Williams is a pretty good tackler in the open field, and Masoli, that's what really jumps out at you, the strength.
Another strong runner, LeGarrette Blount. No room to run, though. Cameron Jordan, the first man to get there. Tyson Alualu helped him out. And a loss of four.
Both defenses are going to continue to lean on the run. They're going to get numbers on the line of scrimmage. I think both defensive coordinators understand it's going to be a real challenge for the quarterbacks to exploit the secondaries with the pass.
Well, it's getting dark here too in Berkeley. They don't have the lights on. They got some temporary lights right behind the stadium, but they're not on. Third down, Masoli going to the end zone. It's picked off right at the goal line. Sean Kutus. It's been a big play defense that has caused turnovers, and they come up on another big one. Not sure that was the rain.
Now this Cal secondary doing a great job this season of getting back, reading the eyes, and reacting to the football.
College football on ABC, brought to you by the Volkswagen Routan, the only minivan in America with German engineering. Aflac, ask about it at work. And Dr. Pepper, drink it slow, doctor's orders.
Legendary musical venue here in San Francisco, right across the bay. We might see a little bit more of that as we go on. Mr. Norrie, you know what, he does a lot of things in his off time. He's not working here in the booth. Sees a lot of the cities we go to. First down, Cal keeps it on the ground. That's Vereen, short gain over the right side. Todd, it's wet where you are. I like being up here in the booth.
Well, David, Terry, I don't want to say it's raining hard, but there are reports that animals are forming two by two outside of Memorial Stadium. Quick update on Kevin Riley. You know, at the top of the show, we talked about a movie, Trading Places. Well, Dazed and Confused, he brought him out there saying they're going to hold him out for observation, but he clearly is not quite sure where he is right now. Also, keep an eye on the skilled players' hands. They're awfully red. They are not eating cherry pie with their hands. The towels are bleeding because the footballs are bleeding. And it's not blood. It's just the leather dye that's coming off. So that might play a factor because it is continually pouring.
Wow, the red coming off on the towels. Anytime you use new footballs or new basketballs, it's tough. It's slick anyway, and now with the rain.
Yeah, and each team only has a certain number of balls that they can rotate in and out of the game throughout the course of the afternoon. So the condition of the footballs, Terry, they deteriorate as the game goes on. And they're tougher to handle. And you really have to rely on the officials and the guys there on the sidelines handling the footballs to do a good job for you. Some crews are better than others.
It's not natural turf here either. It's, you know, about field turf and the old AstroTurf. This is kind of a unique mix here at Memorial Stadium. Longshore throwing on the out. Sean Young, the catch near the sideline, but he's out of bounds. Incomplete. He was out. Nate pleading his case.
Well, this was a nice throw from Longshore, and not great footwork. I'll tell you what.
He's in.
I think he got that left foot down as he secured the football.
Oh, yeah.
That's got to go back upstairs. Every play is reviewed by the officials. They're going to take a look upstairs, a second look in the booth.
Yeah, Longshore, right, well, he's going to signal that anyway, but it did look like they just expected that was a good catch. So they'll come over and take a closer look, but it looked like Sean Young got that foot in.
I've been very impressed with Nate Longshore and the way he has thrown the football in these conditions since he came into the game. He has made a couple pretty throws for Cal.
Obviously, he's not a rookie. He's been through this. He was the starter. He's had a terrific career the last couple of seasons, even though he had the injury last year at Cal. But it's not easy to sit on the bench, not know if you're going in, and then in a split second come off and run the show.
Well, he's been very good at times over the last 3 years for Cal. If there's a knock, he's not had great Novembers. Some well-documented losses against USC, but everybody struggles with the Trojans. And that is a nice catch and an even better job of getting the left foot down along the sideline.
And he had control.
Anytime you can hit a post corner ball for about 24, 25 yards in this football game, that's a real bonus. Big plays are going to be at a premium.
While we wait, a reminder, Jimmy Johnson just running away with the thing, you think? In his march toward his third straight Sprint Cup title, the rest of the Chase Field trying to hold him back. The chase for the NASCAR Sprint Cup continuing with the Dickies 500 at Texas on ABC tomorrow. NASCAR countdown coming your way at 3 Eastern time.
Not exactly the hotbed of NASCAR racing
after
down in Texas, but they like that.
The pass was caught inbounds. California ball. First down and 10 on the 33-yard line.
Yeah, good call. Once they took a look at that, the ruling on the field was he was out of bounds, but he did get that foot down.
That's a nice reversal. And not a tough reversal to make after you take a second and third look. Nate Longshore has been in rhythm here in the second quarter.
48 touchdowns and over 6,300 yards. They'll move the chains. They'll place it at the 33. Been a steady rain and hard driving rain at times since we started this one. More in motion. The tight end comes back this way. Longshore hands it off. Shane Vereen is pounded right at the line of scrimmage. Maybe ahead for one. That's it. Remember, these two teams, 2 of 4 in the conference with just one loss in conference play. Technically, it's the teams at 3-1 are not tied for first. They'd be a half game behind. But USC maybe with the easiest road. Still has to play Cal, the Trojans do. And Cal, though, gets to play USC and Oregon State. They control their destiny.
Yeah, well, and in Oregon State, of course, with the win against USC, what a tough schedule remaining. But the Beavers do control their own destiny, and they will match up later with Cal.
Yep. Longshore throws. Lost the intended receiver. Incomplete. You surprised we haven't seen the lights here yet? Any lights put on?
I think it's only a matter of a couple more minutes before they start turning on the juice. This is as dark a venue as I've seen,
isn't it?
Seen in a while on a Saturday. And really, Terry, it is, it's tough to downplay the importance of this game. This is one of the bigger Pac-10 games that we've seen, you know, early, mid-schedule for the conference.
Of course, the Trojans still with an outside chance to make it to the national championship game. And then the other three racing to make it to the Rose Bowl Pac-10 title. They set up the screen, incomplete. And Longshore now 4 of 10 for 52 yards since coming on for Riley.
You're going to have to be disciplined in this game as a quarterback. And sometimes punting the ball away in a driving rain isn't the worst thing you can do for your team.
Brian Anger on to punt. Jarris Bird back at his own 25. Oh, Anger barely got it off. That snap was a little bit wide. So they'll down it at the 22-yard line. A punt of 43 yards by Anger, one of the best in the Pac-10. So Ducks going to take over. Mike Velotti, the dean of coaches in the Pac-10, 14 years. We'll talk more about his success in Eugene when we come back.
You're watching ESPN College Football on ABC, presented by Best Buy.
Come on right now. Those are just work lights. Those are not game lights. They usually bring in temporary lights for game day if it's going to be into the nighttime hours or dark during the day. They haven't done that this week, so we're going natural all afternoon, and it's pretty dark. Masoli under pressure gets away again. Not in the end, though. Cameron Jordan finally ran him down. Now, I mentioned the career that Mike Bellotti's had in Eugene. Pretty remarkable in his 14th year, David, and still going strong.
Well, he is the dean, and he has set the bar fairly high. He's right up there with the biggest names over the years in the conference. Guys like John Robinson, John McKay, Don James, Terry Donahue.
Northern California guy, born in Sacramento. Jeremiah Johnson, the carry over the left side.
Look at his career wins, rising up the charts. Most in school history, obviously. 11 bowl appearances in 13 seasons. Look at this shot.
I was showing this one because we all age. Is that the 2001, going to that 2002 bowl game, the great year. And now in his 14th season, won the Sun Bowl last year.
Ooh. Looks like Tupou. Big left tackle. Favoring that left leg area.
Finoki Tupou, the senior from Sacramento. So he hobbles off, and it'll bring up third and nine. Prior to the game, we had the coaches wired, and Mike Bilotti was talking about weather, and the Cal guys accusing him of bringing it down from Oregon. And they've made a point to point out it has not rained in Oregon. It's been dry. This is Berkeley weather now. Masoli thrown off his back foot, tipped up, almost picked off. Ezef on the coverage. And they had a couple of those last week where the ball, they'd tip it up, brought a couple back for touchdowns.
Now, Ezef had a 69-yard interception return for a touchdown a week ago. Remember, Ezef was the hero of the game a year ago. Made the hit against Cameron Colvin on the half-yard line, forced the ball into a touchback. 31-24 win for Cal, and pretty nice break on the ball on that third down pass attempt.
Cyree in the punt, almost slipped through his hands. Zaquan Thompson over to his left at the 30. Hit right away. Well, good stick and not much going on. 47-yard punt. Well, every week, I mean, we saw a shot coming back from break a few breaks ago, but every week David checks out the local music scene. There's a lot to check out here, including a legendary venue.
San Francisco has as rich a rock and roll heritage as any city in the country. And for me, my favorite live music venue is the Fillmore. It's hard to believe that legendary rock promoter Bill Graham opened the doors on this standard over 50 years ago. And the acts that have played here read like a who's who of rock and roll. Led Zeppelin, Santana, Pink Floyd, and of course, the icons of the local music scene, the Grateful Dead.
First play from scrimmage, a little bit short, but Jerry Garcia is still thrilled about it. He's pumped up. Now that's a great place, isn't it?
Oh, it's unbelievable. The theater, the intimate setting, you have the bar area off to the side. And well, I mean, you know, we mentioned a few of the acts that have played there over the years, Terry, but other bands like the Cream, you know, the Who.
Oh, there they are. Your top five. Jesus Zeppelin and the Stones. You got Zeppelin ahead of the Stones there.
That's a tough call. I almost had to, you know, place him in a tie for first.
The only band that is not on that list who would be among those would be Beatles. Shane Vereen breaks through. Still up. Across the 40. He's got a first down as the rain continues to fall. Gain of 17. So you've got Best, who's fumbled a couple of times. Vereen comes on for him and busts through.
Cal's offensive line has done a nice job throughout the first half, creating some openings for Best and Vereen. We've seen glimpses of the big play potential of this run game. And of course, Alex Mack, the center, really keys this attack on the ground. He is the bell cow up front.
Boateng in motion. They're coming this way. Job at Best this time. Another fumble. Knocked free, and the Ducks have it again. It was Vereen who was hit and fumbled. What a stick. Well, we've seen some big-time hits by this Oregon Duck defense.
Yeah, this has been one of the harder-hitting games that I've seen in the Pac-10 this season.
And it was Vereen on the carry, and that ball went about 15 feet up into the air.
And T.J. Ward, the free safety, has been flying around making big hits. And let's see who gets in on the activity.
That's
here.
Him.
Again, it's
yeah.
Ward. Ward has had an unbelievable game. Putting his helmet right on the football. And then the Ducks rally with numbers.
So another turnover gives it back to the Ducks. They take over at the 46. First and 10. Four turnovers now for Cal. Masoli rolling out. Looking for a man, nobody down there. Going to run it after a gain of about two. He's out of bounds.
Looks like Masoli's favoring lower extremity there. Be the left ankle or left knee. Cal's done a nice job of winning the battle at the line of scrimmage. They've gotten enough penetration in the first half here to disrupt the spread option attack.
There's 6 points on the board. They're bringing it this way. Terrence Scott. Run out of bounds and some extra jawing after. We've seen a lot of that today too.
That's a nice little wrinkle by Chip Kelly, the offensive coordinator there. We're getting Scott involved. We'll bring him in motion. Now the wide receivers that get quality time, he's probably the fastest of the Oregon Ducks on offense.
They'll run it with him. They'll run it with Jeff Mayle as well, the slot receiver. Not just a part of the passing game. Garrett Blunt in the backfield. Going to get the carry right at the line of scrimmage. Wrapped up Anthony Felder, the inside linebacker and a senior from Seattle, used to this rain.
If you look at the three main perpetrators, the ball carriers on offense for the Oregon Ducks, of course, Masoli at quarterback, you have Blunt and Johnson at tailback, combined over 1,500 yards. We're still in October.
Blunt drops it. Incomplete. So to bring up third down.
Yeah, Blunt is not the tailback you want handling the ball if you have the option. Jeremiah Johnson a little bit better catching the ball.
All right, David. Time for our Aflac trivia question. Which football coach has the most conference wins in Pac-10 history?
That is not. You guys are lobbing me softballs.
We talked about Mike Bellotti being the dean of coaches now in his 14th year.
Is that as good? A question is they can come up with it. They were lobbing the softball.
Actually, it is. Yeah. Basoli wrapped up behind the line. Cameron Jordan. So the sophomore's been in there often.
Well, I'll give. I don't normally give the viewers a hint, but.
What? You got to remember, it's not as easy for the viewer. They.
Well, I'm going to give it away if I say what I'm. If I explain it, I can't do that.
So the tension. Mounts.
Yeah, a lot of drama. Fourth and 10. Tyree on the punt. Saquon. No, they're not going to. Here he is going to throw it off the fake. Got to get inside the 30 down to the 27, though. And they're going to come up shot. That was Justin Roper who was back there. Number 11. The backup quarterback now. Coming up shy and Cal taking over with the 3-point lead. The rain continues to fall here at Cal. It is 9-6. The Bears ahead of the number 24 team in the nation. Little trickery by the Oregon Ducks on fourth down, coming on in punt formation, but it's Roper, the quarterback, back there, not Cyree, the punter.
Yeah, Ducks get a little sneaky and they walk Roper, the backup quarterback, onto the field, and you can see the Cal defenders pointing. They recognize that Roper was in the game. Nice reaction by the punt return unit to make the tackle short of the first down. Remember last week, UCLA tried to pass on a fake punt, and the Bears turned it away.
Came up just shy last week on fourth and 23. So it's first and 10. Longshore, who came on to replace Riley, who was hit, knocked out of the game earlier, throws a little bit low. The intended receiver, Jeremy Ross. Incomplete. Casey Matthews on the coverage, a guy in the middle linebacker spot who has really earned the starting position through the year gradually. All right, our Aflac trivia question. Slam dunk for David.
Yeah, I mean,
most wins, Pac-10 history.
This was an easy one for me because it was my coach at UCLA, Terry Donahue. 20 years the head coach at UCLA. And there have been some great ones in the conference. We mentioned that Mike Bellotti is slowly moving up the charts, but Don James, John Robinson. John McKay.
Initial man not open. Checks down. First down and more. Boateng still on his feet. Inside the 40 of Oregon. A big gain. And they're celebrating here in Memorial Stadium. Tough day to be out here watching a football game. But a gain of 32 and Longshore picking it up.
I think Jeff Tedford and his offensive coordinator Frank Cignetti have found some playmakers outside. We talked about Vran Tucker, but Boateng, number 8, also gives you some size, some playmaking ability, some big play potential after the catch.
First catch of the afternoon for Boateng. Green straight on through down to the 30. The man who fumbled on the last possession. T.J. Ward eventually stopping him there. But the clock continues to run here in the second on a dark, cloudy, rainy, windy. Got any other adjectives? Throw them out there.
Blustery. Blustery. How about blustery?
Blustery, yeah. Mysterious looking day in Berkeley. And they do not have the lights this week.
How about miserable?
Yeah, well, if you're sitting out, if you're Todd Harris right now, you agree with that.
Todd's really earning his money this afternoon.
Second and three. Here come the Ducks after Vereen gets through the initial line. Tripped up, but he's got a first down. Thurman tripped him up, may have saved a touchdown. Todd, you're nice and dry and warm down there, aren't you?
You know, to quote Bill Murray, I don't think the heavy stuff's coming for a while. I'd keep playing. And I'm really disappointed in David Norrie, the fellow Portland man. David, this is like the good old days back at Civic Stadium. You just dumps. This is good stuff.
You thrive in these conditions, Mr. Norrie.
Well, I can't wait to get out of the booth when this game is over and just get down and frolic on the turf for a while. We get a little touch football game going down there afterwards, Terry.
Yeah, maybe down there. Yep. Mm-hmm. Just wait for me. First and 10. Long short. Goes over the middle. Had a man initially and underthrows him. He had him open right away, more of the tight end, and was a little bit late.
And Nick Reed applying pressure. Now, Nick Reed, I think, makes the play here and avoids a touchdown throw. Gets up into the face of Nate Longshore. And look at that spin move. It's such a great job of setting up offensive tackles. Has the ability to beat you with speed to the outside. Mitchell Schwartz, the left tackle for the Bears, has his hands full with Nick Reed.
Leader in sacks in the Pac-10, second in tackles for lost, and just a good old-fashioned football player. All right, so Cal burns their second timeout. It'll be second and 10 when we come back.
Ten elite universities stretching across four western states. Steeped in the values of academic excellence, driven by the mission of being the nation's premier athletic conference. The destination for student athletes competing at the highest level. The Pac-10, the conference of champions.
9-6, Cal with the lead, 4:01 left until halftime, actually, just over 4 minutes that you see. Number 24 team in the nation in a big matchup here in the Pac-10. Man brought his duck down.
Just one of the many quack addicts that have shown up.
Yes.
At Memorial Stadium this afternoon.
Got a lot of fans down from Eugene. Sticking around here, used to the rain. Vereen in at tailback. Darrell Cunningham in motion. As Longshore is under center this time, Shane hit hard right at the line of scrimmage and dumped right there. Well, Casey Matthews, a guy who was not starting. He and John Bacon were kind of sharing that middle linebacker spot. And just over the course of the season, week by week, Matthews has earned the starting role.
Yeah, he got a start 3 weeks ago and has taken control, playing most of the snaps at that middle linebacker position. And you got guys like Paysinger and Pleasant, Boyd, providing some speed at the outside linebacker position.
And every team is banged up at this point in the season, but Paysinger was out with a hamstring, so too for Boyd. He was injured. Longshore throws over the middle, incomplete, almost intercepted. A little bit high and behind the intended receiver.
Looked like Lewis, the safety. Nice job of playing the football in the air. Now, he didn't come up with the interception, but he kept his depth. And that is a tough ball to play off the deflection. More a tight end capable of getting down the field and stretching you vertically with the speed.
Tavecchio on for the field goal. Now remember the snap that was dropped by Longshore the last time. Giorgio getting set for a 41-yarder. Good hold. Line drive kick this time and not going to get there. He just squirted off that left foot. And Jeff is going to ask, so what the heck happened here?
Yeah, when you hear the ball off the foot in this weather, it's a different sound. It's more of a thump.
Todd, what do you have?
Well, guys, Giorgio Tavecchio, he is an immigrant from Milan, Italy. Now, just about 4 months ago, he was signed, sealed, and delivered to play soccer at UC Davis. He gets a call, and he gave me the date. It was May 28th at 4:01 p.m., and Coach Alomar called him, the special team coach from Cal, and said, "How'd you like to be a Bear?" Suits up just 3 days to start against Michigan State.
Yeah, he gave me the date and the time to the minute when he got that call. You don't think he was excited, do you? Johnson with the carry, nothing going there. But he's been fun to watch, Tavecchio, the last couple of weeks. Sheer enthusiasm, genuine, sincere enthusiasm out there. But not on that last kick. Masoli on the run, throws complete to Jason Williams. Along the sideline, out of bounds.
Well, you have to give Bob Gregory's defensive unit a lot of credit here in the first half. And Oregon made it look easy on that opening drive, the scoring drive, but since the early moments of this game, Cal defense has done a nice job solving the dive back and then the options with Masoli and the pitchmen out on the perimeter.
Third down this way. Johnson nowhere to go. You think about the pursuit, and we started the broadcast talking about the Cal defense having to have another big day, but not just creating turnovers, being solid against that run. And after that first drive, they've been terrific.
Well, and this 3-4 defense, as we watch Bob Gregory work the sidelines, get his troops off the field in a punt situation. Some linebackers on this unit, Follett, Williams, and Felder, that week in and week out are capable of making a lot of things happen.
Fourth down, it is the punter, by the way, who's out there right now, Cyree. Does a nice job with the snap. Saquon Thompson back at his own 20. There's a flag initially. And then just collared, taken down by the neck. So you had the initial flag at the 25. And wrestled to the ground. There's Thompson. So we'll see what the penalty early was about.
Yeah, this was Darian Hagan with the block in the back.
All right, microphone not working. I read the lips, though. There was a block in the back.
Field position, so important. A big difference in having the football on your own 25 as opposed to inside your own 20.
How about Eddie Pleasant with the tackle here at the end? Up around the head.
Yeah, that was awfully close to being a flag there.
Right, and in fact, Eddie's looking around to see if there was a flag. You don't want to look guilty. At the end, if you're going to do it, you know,
act like you've been there.
Yeah, nothing wrong with this. Hey, ABC Thursday, 10, 9 Central, an all-new Life on Mars. The next great cop show has arrived, starring Michael Imperioli and Harvey Keitel, after an all-new Grey's Anatomy. What's out there? And it's supposed to be San Francisco. Can't see it today. Yeah, big difference. You're right. 2:09 left until halftime, and you take over now at your own 15. They're going to throw it though. To the tight end Mora, the catch at the 19-yard line, his first catch of the afternoon.
Well, when you sit in the shotgun, you know, you think it might be tougher to handle the football in the rain. I think it's easier. You know, you get up under center, the snap comes quickly, it comes with a lot of force. And if you miss a snap under center, the ball's a lot closer to the defense for a potential recovery. I think in the rain, especially the way that offenses have gone to the shotgun, the preponderance of shotgun attacks over the recent years, it's an easier way to handle the football.
Green runs right into his own offensive lineman.
Longshore choosing to get up under center on that play, get a little north-south action from the I formation.
Justin Cheadle getting the start at right guard. really the guy who stopped Vereen, but there's Kevin Riley. Been on the sideline since that hit. Yeah, USC along with Oregon at 4-1 right now. But as you mentioned, Oregon State, the team that beat USC.
And these two teams, California and Oregon State, the only two outfits in the Pac-10 right now that truly control their own destiny in the race.
And nothing decided this afternoon yet, that's for sure. A lot of football left here in a three-point game. The Capital One halftime report coming up in just a few moments. John and Craig and Doug back in the studio, giving you the day's highlights and all the stories in college football. How about Texas and what they've done and who they've played over the course of the last month?
Wow, and how about that game tonight? Number one versus number seven at Lubbock.
Texas and Texas Tech, maybe the biggest game ever in Lubbock. There's a flag back at the line of scrimmage. Thrown late. Vereen on the catch. There's Nick Reed all over Nate Longshore. And so the hold going to bring it back. And push Cal even further towards their own end zone. The microphone maybe in the rain. Not working now. You mentioned the Longhorns. You think about this last month and trying to get to a national championship, beating Oklahoma, number one, Missouri, number 11, Oklahoma State, number six, and now tonight, number seven.
And we talk about it almost every week. Colt McCoy playing out of his mind, completing over 84% of his balls over the last three games, hitting over 80% overall on the season. And Terry, you know, just as impressive as the fact that Colt McCoy has done a lot of damage running the ball for the Horns. That offense is close to unstoppable.
And the decline penalty, fourth and five now. So anger on for the punt. Bird back at his own 40, and they're still trying to figure out the officials are what they want to do here. They've stopped it a couple of times. No, okay, it's timeout. Oregon takes the timeout. So they'll burn their first time out before half a minute. 12, you get the ball back and maybe they can get something before the break. Think about the remaining games. SC with Cal still on the schedule. But Oregon late at Oregon State, and then Cal has USC and Oregon State. You say, well, it's a tough road. It is, but you want to control your own destiny. They haven't lost yet to those teams.
USC with some prospects of a national title game appearance if they can win out and get some help ahead of them in the BCS standings. But you look at Oregon State, you know, the key games are against Cal and Oregon down the stretch. I mean, I don't think it would be a stretch to say that the Beavers have a shot to win the Pac-10 title outright.
No, I not at all.
An excellent shot.
Hanger back at his own six, quickly trying to get this one off, and just up. Bird backing up. Man's got a powerful foot. Good punt all the way back to the 32 of Oregon with just over a minute left. 48 yards on the punt, under pressure too.
And ordinarily you would say, hey, you know, California's dominating this football game, but Oregon, that's not their cup of tea to possess the football. You know, they go with the tempo game, the no huddle. They run a lot of plays, a lot of their scoring drives, and score quickly. I think Mike Bellotti's worried about time of possession, Terry.
Solely looking for Root, trying to cut back, spins his way out of trouble. And across the 45 and out of bounds. How about that guy, huh?
He's nifty, isn't he?
Well, you think you have him, and we've seen it three or four times in this game already.
Well, and you also get the feel that he's really solidly established himself now as a starter. And Chip Kelly, the offensive coordinator, says he's tailor-made for my offense.
First and 10, going to throw it this time, or wants to at least. No one open. Down the sideline, through the hands, incomplete. And he's looking for a flag. I believe it was Mayo, the intended receiver.
Well, you get a flavor there for Masoli's ability to put the ball on a spot accurately down the field. Rolling to his right. It's tough to hook up on this completion in the rain and the wind, but he puts the ball where Mayo can get to it. Pretty nice throw by Masoli on the move.
Wants the throw again, picked off. Williams bringing it back. Worrell, can he get there? Inside the five. You get a little greedy wanting to put something on the board right before the half. You throw it. And again, a defense that has come up with big time plays.
Yeah, this is one of the better ball hawking units in the country. Four interceptions last week against UCLA. Two of those went back to the house the other way. And Worrell Williams is a skilled athlete at inside linebacker.
Brought it back 47 yards, almost in the end zone. Couple of interceptions today. Look at the numbers for the Golden Bears. Defensively, first and goal, long short, wafting it up, contact, and about eight flags come out. Every official has got a yellow hanky right now throwing it. TJ Ward trying to cover Cameron Mora.
TJ Ward hot under the collar after this call. Well, he's got a hold of Mora. Mora is a tough matchup problem for any safety. Pretty tough matchup problem for a cornerback. The way he runs at his size. I thought it was a good call.
All right, so with the 30 seconds left, Cal down to one timeout here. First and goal again. Out of the eye. Tafou and Shane Vereen.
They can afford to run the ball here with the timeout.
Vereen looks for a space. Nope, back to the line.
Now you got to call timeout right here, and your options are to throw the football on second and third down.
So they take their last timeout. And the four turnovers, 6 points on the board, though. Jeff's had a running conversation with the officials throughout this, well, the last couple of minutes, really, since that last punt, and it continues. And so, you've got 23 seconds left until halftime. There's the man who came up with the big play, Worrell Williams.
And if you're Nick Alioti, the defensive coordinator for Oregon, you're telling your defensive players to play the pass here. Ignore play action. Now, California is not going to run the ball here on second down. You want to play pass all the way.
Second and goal from just outside the two. Longshore thrown on the run to the goal line. Complete. Touchdown, Nyan Boateng with the catch. Miscues, turnovers, a big part of this first half.
It was the interception by Worrell Williams. A great read and break on the Masoli pass attempt. It's going to give Cal a nice cushion going into the locker room.
DeVecchio on for the extra point. Longshore the hold. Gets it down safely. Up and good.
I like the call by Frank Cignetti here. He saves a play action. No play action. Half roll. And that is a pretty nice ball from Longshore on the move in the rain. Boateng beat Jackson, the number three cornerback, and Longshore has looked sharp ever since he entered the game for Riley.
Yeah, they haven't missed much, have they? Hey, this is an offense where, and last week when we came to do the game against UCLA, Jeff Tedford said to us, there's not they are interchangeable to a certain extent. They may not be the same quarterback stylistically and what they do well, but our offense really can run with either one in there.
And he
believes it.
He likes the competition to unfold on a weekly basis. He's comfortable, as you said, Terry, going with either one. And he says the picture isn't as clear as it has been in the past. When you had an Aaron Rodgers or you had a Kyle Bowler, you know, Tedford said, hey, we knew who was going to be the quarterback week in and week out. But with Longshore and Riley, you know, he can sit back and pull the switch, make the change whenever he deems it necessary. And I think Longshore has done a super job coming into this football game.
He had to today because Riley was knocked out. Going to squib this one. Tavecchio is taking at the 22. And that's where it ends, just about the 22. Jameer Holland, a backup wide receiver on the return.
Taking a look at the QB comparison. Kevin Riley had a couple nice throws early, engineered a touchdown drive, but Nate Longshore, some quarterbacks are just better with a wet ball than others. And Terry, we did the USC Cal game up here last year, and Nate Longshore played pretty well in a driving rain on a very cold night against USC. And it was the interception he threw late coming down the field, attempting to tie the game against USC, but he appeared to me to not worry about the wet too much a year ago when we saw him here at Cal.
Seems very pedestrian to suggest it, but I mean, just how large your hands are.
Well, that's a big part of it. That's
a big part. He's a big man. He's 6'5", 233 pounds.
I did not like throwing a wet football, and I was not very good throwing a wet football. I have medium range hands, but unusual for a quarterback that hails from Portland, Oregon.
By the way, they're bringing this one back. Offsides against Cal, so we'll have to kick it again. Election Eve to the NFL's elite. Battle in the nation's capital. You've got the Steelers taking on the Redskins, and don't forget, at halftime, Boomer Chris Berman talking to John McCain and Barack Obama. Their last national interviews were pretty close to it. Monday Night Football on ESPN, 8:30 Eastern Time. At the 31-yard line, the Ducks fall on this. So Casey Matthews, the man who takes care of that, and they'll take it first and 10. Big turn of events, though, with that interception brought back. I mean, Oregon, remember, they call a timeout. They get the ball back, and they have a short time before halftime to try to get something on the board, and the interception leads to 7 on the board for Cal.
Well, Mike Bellotti saw Masoli make a mistake in the first half last week. Lucky for Mike Bellotti and Duck backers, it was with a 23-zip lead, but Masoli threw a pick that almost went the other way for a touchdown, and it was the same kind of ball that jumped up and bit him when Worrell Williams stepped in front.
Masoli took knee there, and we are at the halftime break. 16-6, Cal in the lead over Oregon as we send it down to Todd.
Coach, after Oregon took their first possession down and scored, your defense has been stout. What's been the difference?
They really have. Their quarterback made a nice play on the first one. They had good field position there. But since then, the defense has done a great job of taking away the run game. We've got to keep it up for four quarters.
What can you tell us about your starting quarterback, Kevin Riley, and his status for return?
Well, we got to check it out at halftime. He was a little dingy. He came back. He said he's okay, but we're going to evaluate him at halftime.
Thank you.
Says he's okay. He didn't look okay on the sideline. Pretty shaken up. So Longshore on to do the job. Look at the difference in terms of the turnover margin. 20-1 versus Pac-10 teams when Tedford's teams win the turnover margin battle. Capital One Halftime Report is next. We soared to the second half here in Berkeley, and it continues to rain here. It's been miserable all day long in terms of the conditions. Cal with the lead at the break, 16-6 over the number 24 team in the nation, the Oregon Ducks. Terry Gannon back with David Norrie, Todd Harris down on a soggy field here at Memorial Stadium. So the first half, offensively for Oregon. Masoli throws a couple of picks. They're 0-for-7 on third down, and they haven't been able to rush the football consistently either.
I think the story's been Cal defense once again. They come up with a big play, the pick by Warrell Williams, returns it all the way inside the Oregon 5-yard line. But I think what's been really critical for California is the way they've shut down the Oregon run game. After that opening drive by the Ducks, a scoring drive to open up the game, 45 yards on the ground for the Ducks. They've only picked up 24 yards running the football since.
And remember all the miscues in the first half. It's been very slippery down on the field. Oregon to receive here to start the second. Jameer Holland back at his own 5. Running through what's become an even wetter field. I mean, there's some puddles forming down there, especially around the hash marks. We'll check out our Pacific Life game summary. 279 yards almost per game rushing today, just 68. And the defense, it's a good defense against the rush.
Can't downplay just how critical the Cal's front 7 has been in this game. Oregon's one of the top 5 running offenses in the country.
So it's 1st and 10. They'll call it the 30-yard line. Jeremiah Johnson to call on 1st down. Breaks through, breaks a tackle out to the 48. 1st down. And there is that running game. And maybe Mike Bellotti saying, hey, guys, we got to establish this thing, especially with the conditions the way they are and are going to be.
Well, Oregon has 2 distinctly different backs in Johnson and Blunt. Johnson, a guy that would rather make you miss, but also has the ability to crease you, hit the home run. Of course, Blunt is a big bull type back that would rather run you over.
It's Johnson again, breaks through. Zach Follett able to run him down, but he crosses to the Cal 46, a gain of 5 on 1st down. 2 positive carries for Jeremiah Johnson to start the second.
Of course, this offense a year ago, Dennis Dixon at the helm. Jonathan Stewart running for over 1,700 yards. You have to give Mike Bellotti a lot of credit. Retooling at the quarterback and tailback positions. And the hits just keep coming.
This is a team that puts up over 41 points per game. You're going to keep it on the ground again. Johnson, how did he slip through? Across the 45, stays in bounds. Follett again, runs him down.
And this spread offense, you know, there are so many answers that you have offensively for a defense and the way that defenses play you. Mike Bellotti has a quarterback that's learning how to make those decisions after the snap of the football, when to give, when to get outside, when to keep, and when to pitch.
Got to get to 41 on 3rd and 3. Masoli spins his way close to that yellow line, and the ball comes loose late. It's already stopped.
Well, the question is whether Masoli was still alive. Looked like he was on top of a Cal defender.
It is a 1st down for the Ducks.
Masoli made some comments in the press this week about his confidence in finally establishing himself as a starter. He said, I feel like, you know, now I really have a hold on the job. I feel like I'm the guy.
The coaches have expressed that too. Design run for him this time in a big gain. Gain of 8. And he slipped at the end. Tough to change your direction today.
Yeah, Masoli has excellent vision and cutting ability. Watch him set up his block here and then get up inside of his offensive guard. Look like Mark Lewis pulling.
Johnson looks for a block, looks for a hole, has another 1st down. This is a drive much like the 1st one of the game for Oregon.
It really is.
And Cal somehow figured out a way to stop that offense the rest of the first half. We'll see if they can do it here.
Well, offenses can gain rhythm and they can get a nice little mix play calling with some momentum rolling on the offensive end. And it is very similar to the way the Ducks operated on the opening drive of the game.
Going to keep it on the ground again. Not much going on this time. Ahead for maybe 1. Johnson stopped by Cameron Jordan. We've called his name often this afternoon already. The sophomore from Chandler, Arizona. Johnson says, I need a break. And LeGarrette Blount, the big tailback, the leading rusher this season, comes in.
Boy, look at his frame.
I know.
He is a big boy at 6 foot two, 235 pounds.
Hasn't done it today, though. Minus two on the ground. Cal showing blitz. They pick it up nicely. Masoli throws over the middle, incomplete, a little bit short. Had a man, too. It's Terrence Scott. You see all the red on his jersey, and Todd Harris talked about it. That's the dive from the ball.
That's a play. That's a play that Masoli has to have. I mean, like you said, Terry, Scott's wide open, and if Masoli tucks the football, I think he's got a great shot in the open field to move the chains.
Another third down coming up for the Ducks. Told you they didn't pick up anything in the first half under pressure, thrown over the middle. Complete, but well short of a first down. Ed Dixon, the tight end, who in the last couple of games has not been that productive. Maybe it's the defenses knowing too much about him, but first catch of the game.
This is an interesting area of the field. We talk about decisions for Mike Bellotti. You know, longer field goal try, ball handling has been extremely difficult for the special teams units.
39-yarder. From Matt Evenson. High snap. Nice job just getting it down. This one hooking left, but up. Stayed right there. Evenson good. 39. Had a 52-yarder a week ago against Arizona State at 16-9. Back on ESPN College Football on ABC, presented by Best Buy. Wet, soggy, getting colder this afternoon. Tough to see through the raindrops on the camera lens right now. 16-9, Cal with the lead. Scoring drive and then the 39-yard field goal from Matt Evenson. Slocum Ross back deep. Jeremy Ross coming up to the 15. Across the 25 to the 26. Mike Bellotti's team, long scoring drive to open up the second half. Todd Harris.
Well, Terry, had a chance to talk to the Oregon head coach Mike Bellotti, and he told me he actually was happy with the way his offense was playing, except for the front line. He said they've got to do a better job up front. I said, was that first drive you have a case of Cal doing better defense or Mother Nature? He said it was definitely Cal's defense. He said, but we can run on these guys. We just need our front line guys to produce better, and we've got to get Jeremiah to throw the ball better. One other note, guys, Kevin Riley done for the day, confirmed concussion. He is done for the rest of this afternoon. Terry?
All right, Todd, thanks. Yeah, he went out in the first quarter, so it's been Nate Longshore since then, and Longshore back to run the show. Javid Best back in. Breaking through that initial burst, and Best across the 40 out to the 42. Had problems hanging on to the football in the first half.
Well, whenever Javid Best has problems holding on the football, you think that brace on the left elbow, three games back, the separated elbow, but when you talk to the offensive coaches, it hasn't affected him much. And when he is able to get to the second level, if you're an opposing defensive coordinator, you hold your breath. Nice tackle by Bird, the cornerback in space.
Has the ability to change speeds as well as anyone, I think, certainly in the Pac-10.
He really does.
Boateng in motion. Going to give it to Best again. Can't get away. He dropped right behind the line of scrimmage. T.J. Ward has had a big afternoon.
T.J. Ward has been terrific. We talked about the move by Nick Aliotti to get his free safety up near the line of scrimmage and more of a traditional strong safety responsibility, and use Patrick Chung over the top as a free safety, even though he's listed as the rover. And this team defensively had problems against play action passes against Boise State and USC, and I think they've shored up those problems pretty well over the last 3 to 4 weeks.
Shane Vereen now in at tailback for Cal. He gets the call, runs right past the initial rushers, and then knocked down after a gain of about three. Vereen, the freshman, and the second leading rusher for Cal. Played much of the first half after Best had problems with the fumbles. And there you see, especially down at that end, all the water gathering.
Now, is that casual water? Do I get relief? Is that a free drop?
Is it red or is it yellow? I see, I didn't see. We'll have to get back to you on that one. You don't want to be there, whatever it is. Only yellow line that matters, the first down line here. Longshore, that ball just slipped right out of his hands. But there is a flag. Now, is that ball catchable?
Well, if they're going to call, or at least attempt to call, pass interference. I don't think that ball is anywhere near catchable. You can always drop a flag and call a defensive holding, so we'll have to wait and see.
Moran Tucker out there, and Jarvis
Pass
Bird on
him. Pass interference on the defense, number 32. 15-yard penalty, automatic first down.
So it's called on Bird. Boy, that was about two rows deep.
Yeah, that's an interesting ruling if they're going to call this ball catchable. Let's try to slow this down a little bit. That ball sails on him. I don't think there's any opportunity to catch the football.
If it's holding, that's one thing. But the pass interference.
That was a play that this officiating crew missed. And Mike Bilotti's making the point pretty clearly.
In any case, they put it down at the 40.
I mean, you got an entire officiating crew down on the field, and somebody's got to help somebody out there.
Longshore, straight drop. He's hit as he throws. Got it. Down to the 20. Nyan Boateng inside the 20. His third catch of the afternoon. Oh, Longshore just stayed right in there. Knew he was going to get pounded.
He did stand in strong. And courage is a big part of playing the quarterback position. Looks like Patrick Chung got shaken up on that play.
Will Tukuafu, watch how he comes in hard.
Man, you got to play this position with courage. Sometimes you know you're going to take a lick, but he gets on top of this football on the delivery. That's a well-placed ball on the dig route to Boateng. Mr. Boateng has made some critical plays for the Bears offense.
Lewis comes on. Chung goes off with the injury. He's holding that arm. Javid Best back in for Vereen. His first and 10 is Cal offense. Pretty impressive here to open up the second half. Best dances, powers his way ahead for two. So 8:42 and counting here in the third quarter. Soggy day in the Bay Area of California. Terry Gannon along with David Norrie. Todd Harris down on the field. Thankfully, we're up here. Memorial Stadium. And Cal with the lead, 16-9. Don't forget, these are two of the four teams in the Pac-10 with just one loss. So the winner goes on to be a legitimate contender for a Rose Bowl, for a Pac-10 title. And Cal really getting to the heart of his schedule right now. And Oregon this week, USC, then Oregon State. Longshore. Tipped up, incomplete. Darrell Cunningham couldn't time it.
Cunningham had an opportunity to come up with six on this play. You're going to watch Thurman working inside. Thurman mistimes his jump.
You got to catch that.
That ball is put right on the hands. Now this is another great throw by Nate Longshore and a play that Cunningham has to come up with at this level.
And it is wet. It is slippery, but that's one you'd love to have back. So it's third down now. Vereen in that tailback. Going to set one up coming this way. Right through the hands this time of Moran Tucker. It's one of those where you take the extra time to make sure you haul it in. If you're running before you catch it today, you'll never get it.
Well, each team gets 12 balls that they can bring in to the game. Rotate 12 balls. But oftentimes officials will allow you to reset at halftime and bring some new balls back into the game, even though the rule only calls for 12 balls per team. Looks like they've been using the same ball throughout this game. The ball's been loose on the turf.
And now from 33 yards, Tavecchio comes on to put it up and good through the upright. Giorgio Tavecchio, the freshman from Milan. So they add three more. Tedford squad up 19-9.
ESPN College Football on ABC. Brought to you by the all-new Dodge Ram. Never back down from a challenge. Prescription Flomax and Verizon Wireless.
Was that guy a nun or a bunny? A rabbit. I'm still trying to figure that one out. And I guarantee you they're not sitting outside at cafes in Berkeley today.
Keep in mind, we're in Berkeley, Terry.
You never know. 19-9. Cal with the lead right now after the field goal from Giorgio Tavecchio. Andre Crenshaw, Walter Thurman back deep. But this is a little pooch. And taken up at the 39. All right, David, we talked about it throughout the game, but this a big game in terms of the Pac-10. And I think Cal –
Terry,
really
let's skip the Pac-10 here for a second. We can get to that later. I mean, it's a big birthday for you. 45 today.
Thanks for mentioning it. I appreciate that very much.
You're officially on the back nine of life now, pal.
Well, let me go ahead and make the turn. And it is All Saints Day on my birthday, appropriately enough, if I do so. Thank you very much.
You got them all. Did you make a wish?
I got it. I made a wish. But you're still here. So, well, maybe next year when I'm 46.
I was worried about that. I had a feeling that would be your wish.
First and 10, Oregon. Thank you for surprising me with that. Is there a check in the mail, too? Catch near the first down marker as Masoli goes to the air. And Oregon keeping it on the ground on the last drive, resulting in a 39-yard field goal. And this time, Terrence Scott with the catch. You had that sneaky grin on your face still. You pulled it off, okay? You surprised me. Ball on the turf. Masoli picking it up. And to midfield. Good recovery by Jeremiah Masoli. All right, what I thought we were going to do is take a look at the Pac-10 race. And these two teams in the thick of things, and Cal, I think, really figuring out how good they are at this point in the season.
Well, this is going to be a devastating loss for one of these two teams and a devastating blow to their Pac-10 championship prospects.
Masoli tripped up by Folley. Zach with the big play. And he's been a great one here throughout his career. A senior. Watch the speed.
We talked to Rick Neuheisel, the head coach of UCLA, prior to last week's game with the Bears, and he talked about number 56 being really the straw that stirs the drink for this defense. Versatility and his ability to do so many things off the edge.
In a defense built around its linebackers. Masoli to the air, got a man nailed, can't make the catch as he was hit. You hear a few footsteps at that point.
Yeah, he really did. In fact, he not only heard footsteps, I think he took his eyes off the football looking to avoid the hit by Marcus Ezek. We talked about playing the quarterback position with courage. You have to play the wide receiver position with courage. And I think this is a play that Mayo would tell you he probably should have come up with. In fact, he fanned on it.
So it brings up fourth down. They'll punt it away. Josh Cyree, and it is him, not Roper. They snuck Roper on earlier to fake one. Sidquan Thompson back. Santana comes in before it even goes out of bounds. We take you to break here. 41-yard punt. I'll let you listen. 19-9 Cal up on Oregon, and they're doing some work with pitchforks down on that field, trying to relieve some of the water, which has really gathered on the far side. Not much time to do that work during the break. Cal, first and 10 from the 12. Javid Best in that tailback. Longshore still in that quarterback. He's going to go the rest of the way. And Best can't get outside. We send it back to Times Square Studio, a Sports Center Right Now update from John Saunders. John?
All right, Terry, powered by Vizio. Florida facing Georgia. Important game in the SEC, and Tim Tebow is not going to let Florida lose the game. 44 yards to Lewis Murphy here for a touchdown. He's also run for three touchdowns as Florida is pulling away from Georgia.
Well, John, something had to give there, but it's given in a big way. A bit of a surprise, not more than a bit, the fact that either one could run away with it. Second down, they're going to run straight at that defensive line of Oregon, and a good game for Javid Best. Close to a first down, maybe just a little bit shy. And take a look at our ESPNU All-State standings review. And USC at number 5, you think about the chance they may have to jump up into the national championship picture. Might be tough.
Yeah, it has, and it's gotten tougher over the last week or two, especially if Florida holds on and wins that game. You really have the expectation that both Florida and Oklahoma, one-loss teams, would be ahead of USC. And then if Texas wins tonight at Lubbock, Terry, you've got a chance that maybe Texas and Penn State both run the table, and you've got two undefeateds playing for the national title.
Number 1 against number 7, though. That's no given that Texas will win again against Texas Tech. Stopped at the line is Best. and SC, this is what they have left. Washington tonight, you figure they'll go ahead. And Ty Willingham leaving at the end of the year up in Seattle. And then Cal, you got the Bears November 8th. Stanford, the Irish, and then that last one. Don't take the UCLA game for granted. They learned that a couple of years ago.
Yeah, two big rivalry games, but each one of those football games eminently winnable for USC. In fact, USC should be double-digit favorite in each one of those games. I just don't think the BCS sets up as well for them as it did about 2 weeks ago.
High snap for Anger. Bird back, going to let this one roll to the 45-yard line, just inside. 36-yard punt. Anger's really had to go wide and high and all over the place on those snaps, though, and they at least got it off. And now it's right in the middle of the water, Todd Harris.
Well, Terry, you're exactly right. They've been trying to do some kind of maintenance on this field, but unlike the field in Eugene, it has no crown whatsoever, so the water is pretty much just puddling up, and the left side of the field is just a disaster as opposed to the right side. Also, David Norrie was talking about the limit of footballs you can use. They have lifted that ban. Oregon is using all 36, but what I'm being told is they don't have enough dry towels to keep those footballs dry, so that is the problem they're facing right now.
All right, so if you're in the neighborhood and you got some dry towels, bring them on over and help us out. Jeremiah Johnson, good gain on first down inside the 40 of Cal. And a gain of 17.
Jeremiah Johnson is a back who can really stick the foot in the ground and get the ball north and south, get the ball up the field. Saw his ability to crack off big runs a week ago down in Tempe. Had a big touchdown run early in that football game.
Masoli cuts back. Good gain again inside the 30. Got a first down and more. Run out of bounds. And in the second half, the Ducks getting that running game in gear. Darian Hagan eventually ran him out of bounds.
That was a strong read by Masoli. And Masoli getting better almost play by play. Now, he's not a guy with a lot of experience. Didn't play in spring practice. Missed all of the fall with a wrist.
21 yards on the run, the longest of the game. Johnson, touchdown. ...17 yards to the end zone. It's been feast or famine for this Oregon offense today. They either make it look awfully easy on a drive, or they're stopped and can't pick up a third down. That time it was easy. Evens and on for the extra point. Nothing's a given today. High snap. Again, a nice hold. And up, and it's good. How about a three-play drive? Three plays on that drive. 17 yards, 21 yards, and 17 yards. The big plays, the 21-yarder, the longest run of the game so far for the Ducks.
Yeah, that's a challenge defensively when you line up against the Ducks. I mean, you can be stopping them. You can be controlling the line of scrimmage with your front seven. But eventually they're going to get you in space one-on-one. Look at the job. Max Unger, number 60. All-American candidate getting out, getting a big piece. And then Johnson, he's got terrific feel once he gets up to the linebacker level. Oregon Ducks do such a great job running the football. And it looks like they're going to win the rushing crown in the Pac-10 this year, Terry. As we look at the numbers by half, they're really starting to pour it on here in the third quarter. This would be the third consecutive year that Oregon leads the Pac-10 in rushing.
Don't want to make too much of the conditions, but in this quarter, you've got Cal going into all the water as well, trying to go through offensively, and it's decidedly on that, as Todd said, the left side, camera-wise, and the far side of the football field. It is much different, the conditions there. Right of the 50, it looks at least fairly dry.
Yeah, and you can see right here the way that the water is pooling in this area.
It's Jeremy Ross. No room. Out to the 29. And they'll start there. Reminder, ESPN's coverage, college football primetime, continuing tonight. Old rivals in the Big 12. You got Nebraska taking on number 4 Oklahoma, looking to keep pace in the BCS race. College football primetime presented by Hampton Hotels tonight, 8 o'clock Eastern, 5 Pacific time.
Sooners appear well poised if they're able to run the table. Look at the comparison, Bradford and Gans. Gans is an excellent pass run threat, but Oklahoma, if they can run the table, they stand as good a chance as any one loss team to get into the national title game.
Yep, 7-1 right now under pressure. There's Nick Reed. He got the long short. Man who leads the conference in sacks.
And he has an unbelievable ability to beat tackles and get to quarterbacks. I mean, you see him with his pads off, only goes about 250 pounds. And Nick Aliotti was saying that it is not a chiseled 250 pounds either.
Oh, I'm sure Nick's happy to hear that.
He is a terrific athlete, though.
And first sack of the afternoon for the Ducks, who lead the Pac-10 in sacks. Swinging out to Best, one-on-one. He beats Thurman, but then Thurman gets a lot of help immediately. And they've turned this thing around. Momentum now on the side of the Ducks.
Nick Reed again getting in on that play. He's showing his ability to get to the passer, but also to track down pass catchers.
And that's the other thing the coaches were saying about him, too. He plays whistle to whistle. He might go ahead and take care of his job, and then he's going to go on and take care of somebody else's job, too.
And the coaches call it a terrific motor.
6 of 13 on third down for the Bears. Throws into traffic. Should have been picked off. Incomplete. Lewis right there watching it go through his hands.
Javis Lewis really played his position well. This ball sails a bit on longshore. And as a safety, you've got to be ready for balls thrown high in this weather. And the quarterbacks are going to let the ball go and lose their grip a bit. Lewis lets an opportunity slip by.
Now, Andrews had to go left, right, up, down. You go after him a little bit here.
Well, I think you always test the ball handling, the special teams in the rain.
No, not this time. No extra pressure. Bird's going to watch this take a cow bounce and then field it. Yeah, swung under back at the 29. 45-yard punt. Well, we saw Mr. Norrie at the Fillmore earlier today. I think he's got a little extra right now. Let's check it out.
The Fillmore is an intimate venue, and there's probably no better place to watch a show than up here in the balcony. I mean, can you imagine over the years watching Eric Clapton peel off on a guitar solo or Keith Moon play the drums for The Who? This is a great spot to watch a show. You feel like you can almost reach out and touch the band.
I like that mellow voice you got going on there at the Fillmore, too. Bring that to the table here. Go ahead, whisper for me. Give me the golf whisper. Johnson with the carry. Yeah, they're fired up right now.
They're setting up for a concert that night. They said, hey, keep it down up there, you know?
I see a breaking.
Trying to get ready right, for the show.
Breaking right to left, a little bit downhill.
That comes from watching you cover the British Open.
Yeah. Second and four. And listen to all the Ducks fans here in Berkeley. Masoli. Get his tackle out there to lead the way. Doesn't need him. Runs out to midfield. And then a late flag coming in along the sideline.
I think that's going to be Sid Quan Thompson. Actually, Marcus Ezef, the safety, got a piece late.
See, there's your Fillmore feedback from Jimi Hendrix.
Masoli is now starting to find some creases, and Oregon has had a good feel. Look at Ezef. Not much contact, but it's a dangerous play getting into a quarterback's legs, well out of bounds. And Masoli's starting to make some nice decisions after the snap of the football. And that's what it's all about in the spread offense for Oregon.
Situations like these, the last couple of games, Cal's been able to come up with a big play, a turnover, but Johnson, as they keep it on the ground, tough running. Down near the 30, Brett Johnson, the free safety on the hit. Yeah, they're going to need a big play here because this offense is in high gear now. Under a minute till the fourth. Jeremiah looking to get outside, can't get there. Run out short of the first down. Good pursuit by that Cal defense. And a moment to tell you about ABC Thursday at 10, 9 Central on new Life on Mars. The next great cop show has arrived after an all-new Grey's Anatomy. Looks like Mars there, doesn't it?
It does.
Just San Francisco. I know sometimes it seems like Mars. 1 for 10. Going to pick this one up, though, inside the 20. So change that number to 2 for 11. It was all Masoli. Boy, look how red that towel is from the ball.
These balls literally bleeding all over the field. Talked about the officials lifting the 12 football limit at halftime. And Jeff Tedford wondering whether his defense is starting to get worn down by the quarterback running ability of a Masoli.
Johnson into the arms of Mike Muhammad, who's become a big part of that Cal defense, but another significant gain at the end of the third here for the Oregon Ducks. Cal looking for a way to stop him right now. The train's running on the track. Cal still with a 3-point lead as we head to the fourth. Back for the start of the fourth here in Berkeley, Oregon, and Cal. The Oregon offense finding itself in this second half, but still trailing by three. Terry Gannon, David Norrie, Todd Harris down on the field. Second and a long three coming up for the Ducks. Johnson inside, close to a first down, but now, David, they turn around. They've got to go into the very wet end of the field. It's been a factor.
Well, it has been a factor in, you know, footing, ball handling, all very questionable in the rain. You have to like Oregon and some of the effort that they've gotten from Masoli. Late in the third quarter, you get the feel that the Ducks are really picking things up on offense, and Masoli's success running the football has opened up some creases for the tailbacks.
Third and one. Jeremiah going to hand it off, but they'll whistle this one dead before they go. And they've been movement along that line. Yeah, and that's a big one, too. You got third and one, and now you're looking at a much tougher situation.
Yeah, that's a mistake that you look back on Sunday or Monday and say, hey, that can be a game changer. Huge difference in third and about a half yard as opposed to third and five or six.
Yeah, right.
Changes your whole playbook.
And now you go out of the shotgun. Jeremiah Masoli, Jeremiah Johnson in the backfield. Masoli looking to run. Nope, stopped right there. So that's a huge penalty for the Ducks to stop this long drive.
Yeah, you got to credit Jeff Tedford's defense. Bob Gregory, defensive coordinator. They were playing the run all the way. And that's not a bad way to play a third and five or six in a critical situation. You got to figure that Masoli's probably going to keep in that area of the field, and Alu, the defensive end, making a nice play for the Bears.
Davidson comes on. He made one from 39 yards, this from 29, but in the rain, in the wet conditions. And that's what happens. No good. Looked like he got a pretty good hold. The wide right, and Cal holding on to that 3-point lead. And maybe the difference, the fact that they are down at this end.
And a false start penalty, huge. Now Oregon was operating on offense with confidence, rhythm. False start, they get turned away on a third down conversion. Evenson comes up empty.
Good day to have the heavy jackets on here in Berkeley. 19-6, Cal with a big-time stop. Look at the numbers for Masoli rushing in Longshore with the touchdown pass, who came on, Nate did, back in the first quarter. Kevin Riley on a big-time hit. T.J. Ward, Patrick Chung together knocked him out of the game, and he suffered a concussion, so he's out the rest of the way. It's Longshore's team to run. And at least through this afternoon, keeping on the ground best. Tough running, and how about the conditions down there, Todd?
Well, Terry, as we go to this report, the rain is actually starting to lighten up a little bit, but I just want to give you an idea. We've got over an inch of standing water here in this left end zone. Now, the problem is the ground is so flat, not like Autzen Stadium that has the big crown in the middle that lets the water puddle off and go to the sides. Here it is so flat, it is just puddling in any area possible. Tons of water here. They even broke out pitchforks earlier. Why? To try and aerate the field to get this water to drain, but so far, no luck.
I think he's got a future on the Weather Channel, Terry.
I don't know. He's got those,
covering those hurricanes.
Bruno Mollies he's wearing down there, about $600. He just ruined it. Shane Vereen, as they throw to him, a gain of about four, his fourth catch of the afternoon. But it's, you know, Todd is in that puddle down there at the other end. It's an entirely different situation. And the temperature dropping to, feels chillier than 60 degrees right now.
Well, the standing water is a bit more of a factor right now than the rain. The rain has eased up a little. Both teams have some newer balls back into the rotation. And you like to see that. You like to see a game decided in the fourth quarter, you know, where the football can be handled by the skill athletes.
Good fortune for Cal. Just after that field goal, the rain let up. And the field goal try. This one complete out to the 40. And a first down. Baran Tucker able to hold on along the sideline. Gain of 14.
This is a pretty throw on the post corner route. And the challenge for a quarterback is to drop the ball over the underneath defenders and then in front of the safety. That is a pretty throw. Longshore has made some of the difficult balls look easy down the field.
As a starter and in relief, what he has done today, and the numbers at the bottom, 115 yards and a touchdown, but through the season, a couple of starts and four times on in relief. Vereen, nowhere to go. Walter Thurman in there along with Spencer Pacinger.
Quarterbacks oftentimes called upon to come up. Blitz situations. This time Thurman was to the field. Wasn't necessarily a blitz, but he was playing hard against the run and a nice job of making the play in the open field.
Boy, how one thing can change the fortunes and all the momentum. Oregon had it throughout this second half. Offensively, they had found their rhythm, moving the football. They go down, and the one penalty which backed them up to make it third and six, costing them not only a chance at the first down, but then eventually 3 points.
And the best teams handle those momentum shifts.
Under pressure, just tried to somehow flick it out to Shane Vereen. Nick Reed in there. In a hurry.
Right, Nick Reed is so disruptive as a defensive end. And by the end of this game, I think Nate Longshore is going to be glad that 49 isn't chasing him all over the football field.
He's one of those guys who just looks like he's having a blast out there on Saturday afternoon.
He's got that beard going. Definite Northwest look. What a player. You talk about production. Coaches look for production from their athletes up front, their defensive front. He has great numbers.
Third and long over the middle. They complete it, but well shy of the first down. Tucker with another catch. It's his sixth already today. Guess who was in the backfield?
Mr. Reed. What's new? He said, yeah, let me get involved in some of the special teams action.
Yeah, they told me to come out. No, I want to go back in.
You watch him at the bottom of the screen, and he just, you know, flat out beats Mr. Edwards, the right tackle, off the snap of the football. Too quick to hand.
Yeah, he thought he was collared. He thought he was held.
Donovan Edwards getting an interesting first start.
Angers punt. Bird the fair catch right through his hands. It's loose, still loose. They scramble down at the 5. Cal thinks they have the football. We'll wait for the signal.
Yeah, I think they have it.
Well, they may have had it initially. Do they have it once they separate? Bears ball. And it's been the story of this game.
Mike Bellotti not real happy with Jarris Bird. And I think Coach Bellotti's saying, hey, we didn't even need to really make a play on this football. That is a difficult play in the rain coming down through your face mask, into your eyes. And I think you just tell your return man to let that ball go if it's anywhere near the 10-yard line. Different set of rules for weather.
All right, first and goal from the 6. Can they capitalize?
Well, they're both moving. Yeah, they both have to come set here.
And they did. So the defensive line motioning to them. Here comes Best. There's a penetration. Javid can't get there, but the flag, he had him very high. TJ Ward on the stop.
Yeah, this might be the horse collar rule. Roy Williams, the great safety for the Dallas Cowboys, played his college football at Oklahoma. That was his rule. He brought on the advent of that rule at the NFL level, and over the offseason in college football, it was implemented by the NCAA.
Two fouls on the play. Personal foul, horse collar on the defense. Personal foul, illegal hands in the face on the offense. Two penalties offset. Replayed it at the previous spot.
I saw the horse collar.
And Mike Bellotti's arguing that he not only had him by the neck, you know, inside the jersey, but he also had his hands, his other hand on the body of the ball carrier. And Bellotti arguing vehemently that that should not have been a flag.
Did you see the hands in the face?
I did not see the hands in the face. I can't see everything, Terry.
Well, you usually do, my man.
Thought you'd catch it.
We didn't get any numbers from the referee calling out the penalties there, but a lot to sort out.
Javid Best, a lone setback. Going to go straight ahead, pounded inside, down to the 2, and stopped right there. And again, TJ Ward in initially on that hit. He's been in most throughout the afternoon.
As a quarterback, you get into the huddle here and you talk to your teammates and you talk about ball security. And you got a 3-point lead here. You want to really make sure, especially with 2 downs coming up here, opportunities to score for Jeff Tedford. Make sure you don't put the ball on the turf. And Terry, this would be a great spot for play action. Good sell on a run fake. Got a terrific tight end and Mora to work to down in the end zone.
You got Anthony Miller and Tad Smith in there too, the other tight ends. Going to pitch it out to Vereen. Looks for a hole there to get through. Gets to the blue part. Touchdown. Shane Vereen from 2 yards out. And the lead extended.
The Bears just decided to line up with their big personnel, 3 tight ends, and run sweep. Student body left.
The Vecchio on. Nice snap. Up and through. So the stop at the other end of the field, and then right through the hands of Bird. That's been the story of the day. Vereen for 6. Jeff Tedford knows. Got that 10-point lead. Feeling better right now.
ESPN College Football on ABC. Brought to you by Best Buy. You happier. Powered by Pontiac. Official performance machines of the NCAA. And Allstate. Proud sponsors of college football. Are you in good hands?
The library here at Cal. Last year voted the number one public research university library in North America. 10-point lead for Cal. Coming back from the 15, there's Thurman. Still on his feet. Around the edge and brought down at the 32. There's a flag right there. I don't know if somebody got a piece of the face mask, but.
Or it might have been another horse collar.
Horse collar, maybe. You're getting used to that term, aren't you?
Well, you know, all these rules are really based on keeping the kids healthy.
There you go.
Automatic first down.
See, you do catch everything. Yeah. Hey, don't sell yourself short now, my man. Go ahead and tell us about the Pacific Life game summary.
Leave me alone over here. They're looking at the Pac Life game summary. A big turnaround in the fourth quarter. In Oregon only 112 rush yards, a number five rushing unit in the country, and what a turnaround. Really.
Big time turnover on that last one, though, by Burr, giving Cal first and goal inside the five, and they capitalized. With Garrett Blount, the big back, driving those legs out close to midfield. And Blount splitting time, but a bit shaken up on that. Looks like that right wrist he's holding. Splitting time with Jeremiah Johnson, who's got more of the load this afternoon. Yeah, may have taken a helmet right on that wrist. Second and seven out of the gun. Masoli's going to carry it, run right into the arms of Zach Follett. Follett on that edge, making great decisions today. Let's check in with Matt Weiner.
All right, Terry, Sports Center in-game update on Florida State and Georgia Tech. The Seminoles with a chance to win this down the stretch, but Marcus Sims near the goal line has it popped loose by Cooper Taylor. Hat on the ball. Tech wins its first in 13 meetings with the Seminoles. Pittsburgh has just defeated Notre Dame in four overtimes.
Matt, thank you. Back here, Masoli looking for the first down. Is he going to get there? Using his strength, using a little footwork, and they'll move the chains. So Jeremiah Masoli in this second half, for, you know, it was the penalty late in that drive, which eventually they had to try for the field goal. They missed that. The offense has been moving the football.
Well, they have been moving the football, and I think it's been Masoli excelling running the football. He's so tough to handle in space, making you miss. So strong below the waist.
Jeremiah Johnson, nope, nowhere to run. Mike Muhammad on the hit. Masoli, by the way, almost to 100 yards on the ground. 19 carries, 99 yards rushing.
Yeah, Masoli gave the Trojans of USC some problems. He's given a lot of teams in the Pac-10 some heart pain trying to solve the problem of tackling him in the open field. So shifty.
And an extra runner that you have to account for. Quick throw, a little bit high through the hands of Jason Williams. Normally sure-handed receivers today, and coaches that they would make, even if they're difficult, almost impossible today.
Well, a lot of sure-handed receivers not coming up with balls today, but you know, Jason Williams has a background of dropping the football, and it's really been kind of the bane of his existence at wide receiver. Dominant physical stature outside, but he has been known to drop the football from time to time.
Third and long. Masoli caught from behind by Follett. Big time play in pursuit, and it brings up fourth down.
Well, we've watched the game that Nick Reed has had, a defensive end for Oregon. Follett's the same type of player, a guy who gives you great effort, snap the snap, not afraid to track a quarterback down, never gives up on a play.
Cyree on for the punt. Sidquan Thompson again back deep, standing in his own 10. Let this one go to the end zone, and he does.
Yep.
He's out to the 20. 43-yard punt. Like to get some of those back. Big time stand by the defense for Cal, and with 6:06 left, it's a 10-point lead. Back in Berkeley, a little country music. They play country here in the Bay Area?
Not a lot. This is not a big country western area of the country. I'm sure you can find it on a couple of the FM stations.
First and 10, Cal taking over, and maybe time running out for the Oregon Ducks here. 10-point lead for the Cal Bears. I got it now. Here's why we're playing country. Wednesday, November 12th, America's Biggest Stars coming to one event that brings the whole country together. the CMA Awards. Hosted by Carrie Underwood, by the way, is going to be there.
You get outside the Bay Area a little bit, out to the San Joaquin Valley, and up towards Sacramento, Stockton.
The Eagles will be there. Kid Rock, Kenny Chesney, live Wednesday, November 12th.
Plenty of country western fans as you move outside the city.
The rain has stopped, and it's actually much brighter right now than it's been throughout the day. Cal keeps it on the ground, a gain of about three for Javid Best. But 5:20 and counting now, and Cal keeping the football.
Yeah, this is a real critical set of downs, not just possession, but set of downs. And a big third down coming up for this Oregon defensive unit. With the rule changes in the 42nd clock, a lot easier for a team with a 10-point lead to burn clock on you. Pressure sits squarely on the shoulders of this Duck defense.
Big third down coming up for the Cal Bears. Longshore, the inside give to Vereen, trying to get outside, can't get there. Good stop by this Duck defense.
Another great play by Ward, number two.
He's had a big day, hasn't he?
Yeah, he has, and that hit was critical, keeping the Ducks' chances of winning this football game alive. And it looked like Vereen had a crease. Look at number two come up, get his head across.
Initially, they announced it was an Oregon timeout, and then they charged it as a media timeout. We'll sort it out next. So it is a charge timeout to Oregon, which they extended to a media timeout in terms of length. But the initial boos from the crowd here can take those back. And they're down to two timeouts. And Cal ready to punt it away. Jarris Byrd back at his own 35. Brian Anger gets it away quickly. High and short. Byrd with a fair catch this time. Able to hold on up at the 39. 34-yard punt by Anger. So 4:27 left for Oregon to get something done. And remember how critical this game is to both of these teams coming in with one loss in conference play.
So California, if they can hold on, sets up a big game at USC on down the line. And then, of course, they still have to play the Beavers, another one-loss team. This would be a huge win for Jeff Tedford.
First and 10 from the 40. Masoli looks to throw this time. Right through the hands of Williams.
Boy, I'll tell you, number four. You have to wonder on that play. He's out near the sidelines. The ball's delivered right on the money. And this is not an offense that is equipped to come from behind late in the ball game. They're more content to move the ball on the ground, but Jason Williams has to make that play and step out of bounds.
Knocked down over the middle. Guess who? Zach Follett. Got a hand on it.
And when you're on your own 40-yard line, facing a third down here, how about Follett? And Follett looked like he was sitting outside and then made a nice play reading the eyes of Masoli. But Terry, I think we're in four down territory here, even with more than 4 minutes to go.
Plenty of time. Masoli still looking. No one open. Chased down. Gets away. Still up. He's got nowhere to go here, though. Gets a block. And throws it right to the feet of his receiver, Terrence Scott. So all of that and all the time that it took off the clock, and it's going to bring up fourth and 10.
Well, Masoli had some extra time there. I didn't think he had to let the ball go off balance. There really wasn't a tackler that was threatening him late. Look at Alu Alu pursuing. And then Cameron Jordan, number 97. Keith Browner gets into the act. And I thought Masoli had more time at that point. Had Jeremiah Johnson down the right sideline running free.
And this could be the game right here, this fourth and 10, with just over 4 minutes left.
I think you got to go here. 10-point deficit, only two timeouts left.
Masoli run out of bounds. Got to let that one go. Big stop for Cal again. It's been the defense the last couple of weeks.
And a big hit for Worrell Williams. And Masoli gets flushed to his left. This is what Bob Gregory, the defensive coordinator, wants to see. He runs out of room. Once again, Cameron Jordan getting great pressure. And you're right, Terry. Masoli's got to take some sort of shot down the field there on fourth and 10.
Looked like he couldn't get in a position where he could actually turn his body to throw it. But somehow, some way, you can't tuck it and go out of bounds.
You got to give a lot of credit to the Cal defense. 16 points for the Ducks. You got less than 4 minutes to go in this ballgame.
Two timeouts left for Oregon. With it to Best, bounces out inside the 40 to the 39. There's T.J. Ward again. All day long, we've called his name.
Well, he's the unblocked man. He's the safety that Nick Aliotti, the defensive coordinator, wants to use against the run. Oftentimes, the Ducks will get an extra jersey, an unblocked man, up into the picture. That man has been T.J. Ward, and he has done a great job converting on almost every tackle that has been presented to him.
So you watch this clock just keep ticking.
Mike Bellotti electing to keep those two timeouts in his pocket.
Not for long, though. Green stopped at the line. Powers ahead for a couple. It'll bring up third down. Casey Matthews on the hit. 3:08. Now they do take that second timeout.
That's a good use of that timeout. And you know, presents Cal an interesting decision here. If you put the ball up and it's incomplete, then Oregon gets to save a timeout on the third down play.
Third down coming up when we come back from checking in with Matt Weiner.
All right, Terry, and check out our nominee for the Pontiac game-changing performance. Northwestern Minnesota apparently headed for overtime, but Adam Weber's pass goes through Gopher hands off a Wildcat. Brendan Smith, not content to set up the field goal, just keeps on going 48 yards, and that Gopher fan can sum it up for you. Vote for your Pontiac game-changing performance starting tomorrow morning at 9 a.m. Log on to ESPN.com.
Nothing surprises me anymore, Mr. Norrie.
85 scholarships, all the great players coming out of high school now.
There are no shockers anymore, it seems.
No, and nobody's safe. I think we saw that the last two or three weeks a year ago. I think we're going to have a pretty eventful November across the country in college football.
Think about November 1st to December 1st last year and what happened.
I can't believe it's already November.
I know. Third and six. Vereen stops short. Good tackle. So it brings up fourth down. And we get to the three-minute mark in Oregon with one timeout remaining.
I don't think you could go wrong by using that timeout. You want to save 40-second chunks all that you can. When you're on offense, you can control the clock by throwing the ball beyond the chains. Less than 3 minutes to go. I would use that timeout at this point.
Mike's not going to do it.
Part of the reason is you have Masoli, who's not a drop-back quarterback, well-versed in utilizing the clock on clock drives. But if you have a drop-back quarterback that understands that you throw the ball beyond the chains, you can control the clock and keep it stopped on offense. You can't do that when you're on defense.
Garrett Blunt, who was hit in that, looked like it was his right wrist. He's heading to the locker room right now. So they take the
game
delay of game.
Start on the snap.
And we're down to about 2 minutes and 20 seconds game time.
Regardless how you handle the timeouts, Oregon's going to need a score. And they can get a field goal or a touchdown, but then they're going to have to utilize an onside kick. That's assuming that they can come down and score on this next drive. But you have to be thinking a couple steps ahead.
Or run it back if you're Jairus Byrd. Taking that long count.
They bring the EZF in. Looks like the Ducks are lining up for a block here.
Yep. Didn't go after him. They're nowhere near this. It's going to stop. Now they take it at the 14. So 27-yard punt. They down it just inside the 15-yard line. And 2 minutes, 12 seconds left. We're down to that final possession. Oregon with one timeout. So they've got to drive down, score, onside kick, get another one. As David just said, they take over at the 14. It's been a very wet day here in the Bay Area. And a lot of miscues, a lot of turnovers today. They've played a large role in this one.
If the Bears hold on here, you think that'll be a big game next week at the Coliseum?
Yeah.
The Trojans?
Justin Roper, one of those guys coming in right here. He takes over at quarterback. Incomplete. Remember, he threw a pass early in the day. They faked the punt. They brought him in, tried to sneak him in as the punter. And Roper comes on from Masoli.
Jason Williams is really struggling. Did not come back for that football aggressively. Didn't make the catch.
They have to go to the air. So Roper in there right now. Connects across the 20. It's Terrence Scott who's run down. And Masoli, well, earned the starting spot. And the coaches said it's solidly his. But today, 7 of 21. A number of drops. There's no question. The 44 yards. A couple of picks today, too. Roper throws on the run. Nowhere near. And brings up fourth.
Now, Masoli was controlled for a great portion of this game by the Cal defense. It looked like in that third quarter, though, the Oregon Ducks had some momentum for Mike Bellotti. They were moving the ball. It looked like they're going to take the lead, but that execution penalty, false start, third and a half yard, things went downhill.
Johnson gets the carry across the 30. He's got a first down, so they'll keep it on the ground, but they move the chains then. And a chance for the clock to momentarily stop.
What Roper needs to do here is on every play, he has to make sure that he doesn't get sacked for Mike Bellotti and that he throws the ball beyond the chains. And if you do that, you're going to keep the clock stopped. And you can go a long ways in a short period of time in college football.
Throws underneath Drew Davis, the intended. It's broken up.
Those are the plays that you can't have. Even if you complete that to Drew Davis, Cal wants to see you complete that ball because they're going to chew up 15, 20, maybe even 25 seconds. That cannot be an option for a quarterback coming underneath with a tackler hanging on your back. You got to be thinking score and then onside kick.
Middle of the field, got a first down. They'll move the change across the 40 this time.
Yeah, that was a terrific play. I think that was Mayo. Was that Mayo who made that catch?
Tough to tell. Might have been Scott.
Yeah, it was Terrence Scott. A nice job coming back to the football, taking the angle away.
Roper throws on the run. He's got Drew Davis across midfield and out of bounds.
Yeah, that's more like it. You throw the ball down the field to Terrence Scott beyond the chains. You're going to pick a receiver that's anywhere near short of the chains. Make sure that they're near the sidelines, have a clear path to get out of bounds. Oregon's still in this football game if they can move quickly.
Remember, one remaining timeout. This one almost picked off. Davis was the receiver.
It looked like they were going after Hagan. And that looked like safety playing the hit instead of the football. Sean Katus.
Quarterback keeps it this time and dives inside the 40 down to the 37. He's got a first down. So no one really expected him to do that.
No, and that's a risky play because you run the football and you get tackled short of the first down. You use up a lot of clock. Nice play by Roper.
Gain of 12. Whistles blow.
Timeout. University of California, timeout number one.
So Kel obviously not set defensively, and they call the timeout. And just over a minute left here. Back in a moment. Yes, 1 minute left here. 10-point lead for Cal, but Oregon driving, so they need to score, get the onside kick, get it back, score again. Dickey's 500 at Texas. NASCAR. Chase for the Sprint Cup tomorrow, 3 o'clock Eastern on ABC. Right here.
Jeff Gordon's on the pole.
First and 10 at the minute mark. Roper goes down. He can't afford to do that. Cameron Jordan in there. And they'll call that last timeout. They have to now.
You can't afford to take sacks when you're limited on timeouts. Oregon has to burn that last timeout, as you said, Terry. The quarterback again got to be very wary of that first unblocked rusher coming free in the pocket.
If you're still in the stands right now, you are some fan. Now, it's been a great game, don't get me wrong, but horrible weather today.
It's starting to clear up a little bit, not raining quite as hard.
Mentioned that matchup at the Coliseum against the Trojans, then Oregon State. So you're just really starting to get into the thick of things.
You go back 2 years ago, Nate Longshore started in that game, and it was for the driver's seat to the Rose Bowl. And 2 years ago, Cal visited the Coliseum, and the Bears took a lead into the second half in that game. Longshore did not play very well in the second half.
The Ducks out of timeouts. Ropa flushed out, looking, throwing, incomplete. Worrell Williams, who already had a big interception early, almost hung on.
Williams is a linebacker that really jumps out at you when you watch film and you watch how he's played over the course of this football season. He lines up next to Zach Follett. Two superb playmakers for Cal on defense.
Imagine Williams with Sinquan Thompson in high school. High school teammates. Pretty good defense. Roper thrown long this way. Incomplete. Davis tried to go up. Climb the ladder. Arian Hagen held his ground. So it's fourth down. And this final chance.
You cannot say enough about Cal's defensive job. You got to give Jeff Tedford and his defensive coordinator Bob Gregory a lot of credit. Even more credit to the kids. This was an Oregon team last week down in Tempe that looked like no defense was going to stop.
Everybody on their feet here on fourth down. Incomplete. That should do it. So Cal is going to survive here at home. And the momentum in that third quarter leading into the fourth quarter really on the side of the Oregon Ducks. They had figured things out offensively, moving the football, knocking on the door down inside in the red zone, ready to score. A penalty takes them back. They missed the field goal, a fumble on the fair catch on the punt, and it's over.
It turned on a dime in a heartbeat.
Chevrolet players of the game, T.J. Ward, 11 tackles and involved in much more than that. And Zach Follett, who really played a big role. Recognition of their efforts, Chevrolet will make a $1,000 contribution to each university's general scholarship fund. So that's going to do it. Tedford coming over to shake hands with his old friend, Mike Bellotti. And the Ducks are going to fall to 6-3, and Cal is moving to 6-2 on the year, David Norrie.
It has to be a disappointing loss for Mike Bellotti in this program. A lot of people up in Eugene going to be upset about this one, but it sets up a great matchup next week, and there's going to be a real excitement on campus here at Berkeley anticipating that game down at the Coliseum against the Trojans.
They fire the cannons for the W. And Cal with a 10-point win in what was a miserable day conditions-wise here, and it played a large factor, but coming up tonight, don't forget, number one taking on number seven, Texas and Texas Tech, one of the biggest games ever in Lubbock, coming your way. BCS implications there. For David Norrie, Todd Harris, our entire crew, I'm Terry Gannett. So long from Berkeley, everybody. Your final score, 26-16 in favor of Cal.